Yeah. So look.
Hello.
Dream Team's back, everybody. How you guys doing?
How you doing? I'm digging this heater.
Oh man, the heater's nice. It's actually not terrible
it's
at the moment.
Good.
Yeah.
I mean,
you're still bundled up, but you know, I decided I don't need to bundle up now.
Yeah. It's probably like 20 degrees in this basement.
It's pretty chilly. This Coke can is
frozen.
Great. Not yet.
Yeah.
Not yet. Oh goodness gracious! So I hope everybody's doing well. I haven't been back here, and or at least behind the booth in a little while now.
Yeah.
So, happy to be back. I watched some of the last week's stream.
Thursday was good. I thought Nick was good.
Yeah, and I had I keep meaning to tell Nick thank you because and he did do a good job.
Yeah.
So.
He said he didn't like the sound of his voice.
True. And you guys talked over each other a little bit.
Yeah, well.
But
that's to be expected.
I never talk over you, Greg, right? We never talk over each
other.
Right, never. Never ever talk over each other. Oh, Chris, 30 minutes or... Oh, no, Mangaro, it's Monday. Monday we start at 7.
Yeah.
Start at 7. Christian Wright, how you doing? I'm actually going to run upstairs and just make sure that we have a match set up. Do we want to get World Order since everybody was...
Sure.
Shitting themselves about that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Alright, I'll get World Gorger.
Okay. And, what's up, Jeffrey K? Hello, Christian Ryan. Mark's running upstairs to make sure that we get the first match on camera correctly. And what's up, Manigoro? Evan also in the chat. Nice. Yeah, this is Monday Legacy. We're coming from Dice Dojo in Chicago. 7 p.m. every Monday, 7:30 Wednesday and Thursday. Because we come from Card Market then, on those days. Wednesday's Modern, Thursday's Legacy. So, Monday at 7, though. So, that's why we're here right now. We are sitting in the basement stock room of Dice Dojo. So, you guys get to see behind the scene what it's like here. There is a World Gorger combo deck in the room. It's Esper colored currently. It's played by Kyle Norman. You can also, if you want to go back and watch more matches, we had him on camera, I think, twice last Thursday. And he also split the finals last Thursday, so he did pretty well. He's Esper colored. He gets, like, Swords to Plowshares out of the white, basically. And also, like, Cunning Wish for Silence also works. The deck is primarily blue-black, though, and the kill condition is commonly, let me pull it up, Nephalia Drown Yard. So I'm not sure if that's the vintage combo, or the vintage version, like Johnny Turbo's calling out, but basically just, you know, normal World Gorger combo lets you generate infinite mana, but you just have to do something with it. Dev Clock Mark is commentating. He was just running upstairs to make sure that we get a match on camera.
No, I'm not commentating.
Okay.
This little bubble right here is nice and warm.
Oh, it's great.
Yeah. Oh, wow. It's even warmer when you sit down.
Yeah, because I was keeping your seat warm for you.
I know.
People are glad that you're commentating, rather.
Oh, why is this,
Why is what? What? What are you trying to get out of that?
The autofocus seemed to be.
Mark
hype! Hype!
I think people like World Gorger.
Yeah. Kyle wasn't convinced that they liked World Gorger as much as they just didn't understand what it was.
I think they like the idea of World Gorger more than the deck itself. Because
it's fair.
It's like every Reanimator deck. Like, not many people like Reanimator's not a good guy deck. You know? I don't know.
Evan Insgeeks.
What? Just call him Evan.
No, it's Evan Giskins.
Is geekin.
He might be geekin.
Evan is geekin.
Hasn't followed yet.
Oh.
Just putting that out there.
Mark
likes
when...
You make a claim. You make a claim, Evan, and then you don't follow through.
Mark likes when people follow. Blindly. Mostly blindly.
Just blindly, yes.
You haven't seen
anything yet. That's how I got
Greg. Yeah, how did I? Yeah, that's true.
I'm still very sad that I forgot my koala hat because it's very similar to this, except a koala instead of an owl. It would have been good.
Elf Attacker is going to visit soon. That's cool.
Oh, yeah. You seriously?
Nice.
Yeah, come by. For a college visit. I was going to say, let's get drunk.
I'm pretty sure people in college drink.
Well, I guess not with their parents on a college, like that. Anna can't take them to bars.
Yeah, unless they're doing, like, they have certain things,
which I don't, we do not approve of.
Don't condone. Definitely did not have a fake ID when I was younger.
And Evan Skikinskins, thank you for following. Oof. Much appreciated for following through.
6 hour drive, that's brutal.
Secretly just to see you guys. I agree.
Well, driving 6 hours to play Legacy here is sort of like us driving 14 to New Jersey.
Kind of.
I think that's like the proportions are about...
It's like the tournaments are about the same size.
There's a lot of prestige involved with our weekly tournaments.
Prestige. Yes.
I can't say the word.
Prestige? It's the prestige.
Yeah.
Prestige.
Stop it.
We don't know. Spike Mo, hashtag Fetchlands do suck. They do.
And I'm all right with them.
All right. Well, once I go to college there, we won't get drunk, wink.
Boom.
Okay.
Yep.
That's fine. Anyone going to drive to GP Vegas?
Oof.
Well, we've talked about going to Vegas.
It's a long drive.
I mean, we'd fly.
Yeah.
But I'd rather go to Seattle for the Legacy GP than...
I'd rather see the city of Seattle, frankly.
Because I'd probably take the week off and bring Rachel.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. I don't know. Just saying.
Yeah.
Tacoma and Seattle. Oh, because it's Tacoma. Yeah.
So I mean, Tacoma is half an hour.
Is it in
from
Tacoma?
I imagine, because it's cheaper.
Seth Rogen, I love your beard. I agree. All right. Somebody at work told me that I sounded like Seth Rogen as well. I still don't see it.
You're not Canadian.
Is he Canadian?
Yeah.
I'm better than that.
Yep. I mean, you are a Southerner, so I don't really know which is better there, but...
Southerners are always better.
Okay.
Always better. Southerners are better than everything.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's technically in Tacoma.
So it's not far from Seattle.
So, Evan, you should hopefully see us then. It'll be good.
Yeah.
Spike Mo, going to Baltimore. What is...
It's an open in Baltimore, and
what's
it's
the format?
Modern.
That's what I thought.
That's
okay.
The first modern
I thought it was the
open.
Yeah. Okay. That'll be fun.
You would go to a modern open, right?
I would 100% go to a modern. I don't know. I'm enjoying the Tezzeret deck so much. So far, at least.
Nick and I were playing some modern earlier, and he cast Become Immense on me multiple times. It was pretty good. I was playing Twin, though. I think I won most of the games.
And would Simon cast Become Immense?
No, Nick. He's playing Infect.
You know what you run
to
stop that?
What?
Spellskite.
Yeah.
And then you got a 6/10 Spellskite.
Yeah.
Boom!
Well, he had...
Boom!
This is post-board, so he has, Nature's Claim for my Spellskites.
Gotta run more Spellskites.
Also,
right,
Wild Defiance is so good.
You run...
Oh, my God.
You run 4 Spellskites, okay?
Okay.
Buried Rune and an Academy Rune.
Okay.
And 2 Trading Posts.
In my Splinter
Twin
deck.
And your Splinter Twin deck.
Yes.
You will get back... think about that. You go infinite with Splinter Twin.
Okay.
Okay. And then you sack one of the tokens to Trading Post to get Spellskite back.
Yeah.
I like it.
Killer Kevin, yes, someone's playing World Gorger.
Hot Atlanta in the house. All right, fair. We're in Atlanta. Used to live in Lawrenceville. Just saying that.
Are you playing?
I'm just playing Lawrenceville. Woo-hoo! I heard Lawrenceville is a terrible area now. Yeah.
Was it good when you were there?
It wasn't bad.
Was it because you were there?
It was like low. Probably, yeah. It was because I was here. Oh, God. All right, so it looks like people are actually sitting down. Is this... That's Kyle, so we'll go ahead. They're not sitting down yet.
Is there a bunch of bright stuff? Then it's probably Kyle.
All right, so World Gorger. Gorger?
Nailed it.
Did I?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Sorry for the delay. My computer, for some reason, won't let me start from.
Okay.
That's... fine.
And, which I need to stream the stuff to the TVs.
Okay. What is who's Kyle playing against?
Simon.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So is Simon on Enchantress? Do you know?
I have no idea.
Okay.
Well, he didn't ask to borrow my Tarmogoyf, so I would guess Enchantress. I also saw basic forests.
So this will be interesting, right?
Enchantress.
Enchantress.
Yes.
All right.
I think
this is
really bad for Simon.
I think so too. I don't know what he does here.
He can sideboard Rest in Peace.
How do you spell Kamerow?
Kamerow.
Okay. See, that's how I guessed it. Mm-hmm. Kamerow. We'll go ahead and say time
started,
right?
Yeah. I don't think these games should take too
he was messing with and Chuck was messing with his phone. So
right.
World Gorger boys, get it. Get it. All right.
You probably want to
what are we doing?
If you just click on that.
Oh, yeah. You know what?
Yeah.
You're a wise guy, Greg.
You got it.
We got wise guy Schaefer over here.
Yep. Forget about it.
No longer scumbag Schaefer.
Forget about it.
Wise guy Schaefer. From Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
Let me get a pie. Pizza pie.
I didn't send you the thing I wrote for work, did I?
I don't think so.
I should forward it to you.
You should.
They have a weekly newsletter at my job, and they have one person write like a blurb about where they're from every week. So they had me do it.
Yeah.
One week, and I wrote about how everyone's life in if you grow up in Brooklyn, everyone's life is like the movie The Warriors, and everyone's in a gang, and basically everyone dies.
That sounds good. Sounds positive. So Kyle's looking at three lands. Looks like, I think it's a Scalding Tarn, two Drown Yards. Does he run more than one Drown Yard? Am I going crazy?
Yeah, he plays three.
Okay, so two Drown Yards. Oh, no, and then there's a...
Duress.
Oh, yep. All right, I have no idea. I think I was completely wrong on his hand, other than the Scalding Tarn.
I didn't see Simon's hand, but he might be mulliganing very aggressively to specific cards, because he must know the matchup. I'm not totally certain what main deck cards he could have here.
If he gets... No, because, Sphere... Solidarity doesn't do anything. Does he have anything main that gives him...
What's Solidarity? Oh, you mean Solitary Confinement?
Yeah, Solitary Confinement, sorry.
I don't think there's anything that gives him Hexproof...
Main?
That I can think of.
What if... What is Kyle... Like, Kyle's got a wish for, a bounce spell, right?
Right.
But if Simon can go, turn one Leyline into turn two Sterling Grove?
Oh, you mean post-board?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sterling Grove? What does Kyle do?
I don't know.
not a lot. So Kyle's going to go down to 19 here.
All right. So Simon's hand's atrocious. It does at least have an Enchantress effect that's not going to get Duress. So that's nice.
Yeah. So he got rid of the Elephant Grass?
Right.
Okay. And this is...
Is Wild Growth?
Yeah. No, it's not Wild Growth, is it?
I believe it is.
I thought it was the other one. We'll see. Hold on.
Boom.
No, you're right.
Suck it.
Maybe I will.
Don't.
So, Simon's just going to play another land, passes the turn back to... and plays the Enchantress. So, let's bring up...
Argothian.
Is that Argothian?
Yep.
And Enchantress. There
Kyle brainstorming here.
So.
Doesn't need those lands. He just needs to go for the combo as quick as he can.
Yeah, but I mean, even if, I still don't think, Simon can actually do anything. I mean, Kyle's got Dig Through Time, a Wish, and Force of Will in hand. And I think there's an Entomb as well, is there?
Mm-hmm.
So which Enchantress is that?
That is Enchantress's Presence.
Okay. Chant.
So he has his engine set up. The problem is that he doesn't have any disruption.
No. But he's going to be drawing a few cards. Kyle going to go down 18 after cracking that Scalding Tarn.
Right. Probably the best draw here would be Sterling Grove, just because...
Okay, he did have the Entomb.
Okay. Now the question is whether or not he has...
A reanimate spell?
Yeah, and something to actually do with infinite mana.
I'm guessing he does.
He doesn't necessarily. I mean, he can have Dig Through Time.
Does Simon have anything that hates the graveyard main board?
I doubt it. He could have Rest in Peace main.
I'm finally awake to see you guys stream. It's 2 a.m. here. Black Set, thank you for tuning in. I appreciate it. Captain QC, thank you for... how you doing? I don't even know. I've lost my mind.
I think he doesn't have the reanimation spell, and he's thinking about brainstorming. He also has Cunning Wish, or maybe he doesn't have Brainstorm, I can't really tell.
Can Wish get him a way to get a reanimate spell?
I don't... It might. He might have, an intuition in his board or something, but...
Okay.
It seems like he might be wishing right now.
I do know that Kyle put an Enter the Infinite. or pull from eternity, yes. Excuse me, in this board after I suggested it, which right. I like that a lot.
It's something.
No, I mean, like, they go swords, and you're like, oh, well, shit, okay, they have to kill you that turn,
right.
Or else you just get to wish for,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know, I like it. So here's a dig through time. I'll bring that bad boy up.
Delving six, leaving World Forger.
That's smart. I don't know if I like that play, though.
Why?
Huh? I think you delve away World Gorger, and then you get Pull from Eternity. You're just keeping it safe,
yeah.
All right?
That's a good point.
You're just keeping it safe.
Yep.
I like it.
Keeping it for later.
Yeah, I like it.
Yep.
I like it. All right, so... Oh, Ponder, so did he still not find a... Or was that a main phase, Dig Through Time?
Oh, that was definitely main phase.
Okay.
He's shuffling off Ponder. Yeah, he's just
aggressively
going as
looking.
Hard as he can for a reanimation effect.
So he's still got the Force of Will and the Wish in hand?
Yeah. This leads me to believe that Simon does have something relevant in his main deck here. Like, he might have a Rest in Peace in his main. And that means if he hits Sterling Grove or something similar, then this might be really good for Kyle.
Yeah.
Or for Simon, rather. That looked like a forest, though. Ooh, he has Replenish in his graveyard.
Okay.
He might have to Replenish just to dig through his deck more. Like, it's better than doing nothing this turn.
Yeah, that's fair. Let's bring up Replenish. Replenish.
One of my favorite magic arts.
It's a terrible card.
It's a really cool card.
Nah, bad.
Uh-huh.
Bad.
Uh-huh. Oh, Sigil.
Okay.
Going beat down.
So we'll bring up Sigil.
Sigil of the Empty Throne.
There we go. There are a lot of Sigils in Magic. Fun fact.
That makes sense.
Oh, my goodness. All right.
I don't think he has another enchantment in his hand.
I don't think
this
he
does. This is getting
either.
Forced, though.
Which is probably smart on Kyle.
This is great for Simon. Because now he can replenish next turn.
Yeah.
Like.
And he's going to get it back. Does the elephant...
Looks like Kyle has two more lands, a Force, and a Cunning Wish in his hand.
Yeah. But
so he could actually lose this game.
An Elfengrass doesn't actually do anything to stop a combo.
Correct.
No.
This is drawing two.
And that's... Was it Mari's what?
Mary's Guile.
Mary's...
R-I.
R-I.
Two R's.
R-R-I.
Yes.
Mary's Guile.
Yep.
Oh.
It is a weird version of Sylvan Library.
Yeah.
Basically a tuned down version.
Yeah. So.
Alright, looks like.
Thank you, Chuck.
Simon's not going for Replenish this turn.
This is a weird printout. No, Chuck disappeared.
Alright. Mana Bloom.
But.
He still hasn't played a land this turn, so if he draws into Sarah's Sanctum, this could be really good.
Okay, so...
It's like just another basic there, though.
Yeah. Basically, another Enchantress effect.
Yeah, so he can't replenish this turn.
And Kyle does have another Force of Will, though.
Sure, but then Kyle's on nothing.
Yeah. I mean, he could still...
And the turn he's drowning himself. Feels dig through time.
Okay, sure. Here's a Ponder. I mean, to be fair, Kyle's gone through a good chunk of his deck.
He has.
At least seen a good chunk of his deck. And
yep.
Then
he dug and he missed.
There it is. All right.
Game
so,
over.
So, yep. Kyle's already got World Gorger Dragon up. World Gorger Dragon.
Yep.
So, Flying Trample 7/7. Gonna get there.
Yep.
That's not actually the
point. Kyle demonstrating the loop here.
Yeah.
As long as milling Simon out, this is fine.
Yeah. But he's just going to... No, he just Cunning Wishes for...
Sure.
What's it called?
Stroke of Genius?
Yeah. I wish he used...
He can also choose to mill Simon's deck, and then he gets full information on what's in Simon 75.
Yeah, but Simon's probably going to scoop it up before
sure.
he does that. Like, I mean, Simon knows what's going on. How do you feel about Stroke of Genius over Blue Sun Zenith?
It doesn't matter.
I want Blue Sun Zenith.
I think it does not matter in the
slightest. I want Blue Sun Zenith.
Stroke of Genius has better art, so I prefer
Stroke.
All right,
fair enough. All right, so let's see. Interesting matchup. It was an interesting matchup. It's going to get, I think, a lot.
I think pre-board's real bad for Simon.
Oh, I do too. I mean, as soon as Kyle has the combo, then he just wins.
Yeah. That was a bad draw for Kyle, really. And it still didn't, like, the game wasn't close. Kyle had multiple more turns to find his combo. Yeah.
So, all right, so I hate that you can't play anything on your opponent's turn. Oh, on Hearthstone. Okay, sorry. They're just talking about Hearthstone.
Have you ever played that game?
Yes.
I have not.
I play it every once in a while just because I've never put any money towards it.
Okay.
And so you're at a little bit of a disadvantage. I also don't know the deck archetypes that well.
Okay.
So I kind of just jam things that I think are kind of good together, which...
Do you think that the game has a lot of depth, like if you did get into it?
It's got a decent amount, I'll say that. Okay. Yeah, I'm not going to... It's not nearly as complex as Magic.
Sure.
But there are... I think, more so than anything, you're very, very, very rewarded for knowing... Because the deck size is smaller, so, like, knowing what cards are in a certain archetype.
Okay.
And what the archetypes are that you're playing against.
Sure.
And I think, like... If, as long as you know those things, then you're going to have a much better time at Hearthstone.
So there's a lot of metagaming?
Yes, I think so, too.
How often do they release new cards, or do formats just become solved and stale?
They release cards every pretty quickly and stuff.
Okay.
If I remember correctly.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, as far as, like, solved and staled, I don't know enough about the... I haven't played enough to actually get there.
Elf Attacker asks if there's a benefit to running World Gorger over normal Reanimator. The benefit really is that you kill on the spot. Normal Reanimator, you get Grizzlebrand, but then you give your opponents multiple draw steps to find things like Swords to Plowshares or Caracas or any number of cards. It is worse in the sense of you basically need three cards, kind of, to win. Although it's not totally true because... Kyle's playing a bunch of sort of incidental win conditions as the third piece. You know, like, he still needs Entomb plus a reanimation effect. But then, to go along with that, he could have any number of cards in his deck, such as he could just have Nephalia Drownyard.
Piranha Marsh.
He could have Cunning Wish.
Piranha Marsh.
He could have... I don't know what that does.
Piranha Marsh is this... It comes into play tapped.
Okay.
It's a swamp. It's a land. And it causes your opponent to lose one life.
Okay. He could have Piranha Marsh.
Thank you.
So he's not playing.
Thank you.
He could also just have Dig Through Time and find Cunning Wish.
Could have Blood Hall.
This is a good point.
He could... also, before we missed, because it already scrolled off, there was a question of whether Enchantress and Legacy runs Eidolon of Blossoms. I think the consensus is no.
Yeah.
A lot of people do not like it. I know Simon hates that card.
Yeah.
The
problems that Simon cited are just, it's too expensive. It dies to common removal, whereas, you know, the other Enchantress effects don't die to normal removal, like Lightning Bolt or Swords to Plowshares. And also, the draw trigger is on entering the battlefield, not on resolution. Not on casting, rather.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, so, yeah, like, that makes it a lot
stuff
worse.
Getting countered is
big.
Pretty common in Legacy.
Yeah. And then, I prefer bagels. You want the Enchantress list? I'll talk to Simon. We might be able to do a deck tech at the end of the night. If not, I'll get him to post it on... I'll get him to post it on the Facebook page.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think his list is fairly stock. Overall.
Oh. Evan also brings up a point. You can, if your World Gorger is losing, they can just draw the game.
This is true. Well, you have to complete your combo, sort of, to draw the game. But
sure.
Yeah.
Ooh. And there's a ley line right off the bat.
Yep, that's good. Kyle's going to need a bounce spell.
Oh, wow. All right, so let's pull that up. Yep. Leyline of Sanctity, it's basically giving him Hexproof. Actually, no, it's... I guess it was retcon too. You have Hexproof.
Right.
Ways
that Kyle can get around this. He can... If he has Cunning Wish when he makes infinite mana, he can find a bounce spell. Ooh. It's basically just going to slow Kyle down a little bit, I think.
Yeah. He's going to... He basically Cunning Wishes for Chain of Vapors.
Okay.
And kind of goes for it.
Yeah.
So
Simon really needs something like Rest in Peace, too. Like, I don't think the ley line is likely to carry the game by itself.
Damn. Prime Marsh does target. I was really hoping it didn't target, and it was just opponents lose one life.
Oh, sure.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
And then he wouldn't be able to fucking argue against it.
Then it would be great.
Yeah. All right. Fair enough. All right. Let's still do this. Simon's got a wild growth just passing the turn. Kyle looks like did keep the ponder, but we're going to see the Argothian Enchantress come down again. And then just a pass back.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine we're going to see another ponder from Kyle.
Someone's asking if there's any 12 posts in the room.
Nathan was... No, because... People... Never mind, that was a conversation about how much we hate Cloud Post. But, well, in relation to Mud.
Okay.
And Nathan was like, that's why he stopped playing Cloud Post, the deck. Because it was
People have played in the past here, but not often.
Yeah.
Like, Alessandro used to play Cloud Post sometimes.
He still breaks it out every once in a while.
Yeah, he has the cards. I think he has the candelabras. There's not many people who could say that.
Wait, things are like... Oh, okay. I see. Wait, Leech Ridden Swamp? What's this? Hold on. Does this...
Here's another Enchantress's Presence for Simon. And here's Entomb. Kyle might just have everything.
Does he?
I mean, if he has Drown Yard and Cunning Wish in addition to Animate Dead, then that should be the game.
Oh, that's true. And Piranha Marsh would come back into... Well, it doesn't matter because you don't need to generate infinite mana with Piranha Marsh because it's just coming into play and they're losing a life.
Right.
So that was something about that. But, yep.
By the way, Kyle should be at 19.
Sorry about
You're
that.
You're fine. I think the game might be ending right now because I think Kyle might have multiple Cunning Wish... Wishes, actually. Yep, two Cunning Wishes.
Oh, wow. That is a defeated thumbs up from Simon. Yeah. There's just like a...
This matchup's atrocious.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
This is way worse than normal Reanimator for him. You know, like, he has more ways to interact with normal Reanimator.
Wow. All right, so he actually got... Kyle went and got Echoing Truth.
Yeah, then Stroke. Wow.
All right, so we'll bring you back to the booth. I'm going to run up and try to find another match.
Okay.
If you want to reset stuff.
Yep.
Kyle, and I'll be right back.
Kyle's sure to show that you still had all these at the end there. I don't know why. Yeah, that matchup, pretty horribly lopsided. One of the I don't know, funny, weird things about Legacy in general is just you have more of those... 90-10 matchups where you don't really get that in standard ever, you know? But Kyle's running, or Mark's running upstairs, seeing what else is in the room. And I can actually, I have a list here of all the decks in the room, so I'm just going to read them out so you guys have an idea of, like, what we can pick from. Looks like Tony is on Esper, like, mid-range with Stoneforge Mystic and all the other things you'd assume were there. Bob is playing, it says mono black. I don't know if that means like pox or what on earth that exactly means. Simon Enchantress, Kyle World Gorger, we just saw them. Christian, I'll ask Mark in a minute if there's a giveaway. I suspect there's not. He hasn't mentioned it to me, but I'll definitely have him confirm or deny that. Kyle Houtman's on Sneak and Show, Greg Pino's on Maverick. Joe is on Reanimator. Nick is on Miracles. Nathan's on Rug Delver. Bowman is on Lands. Ryan's on Esper. And Bogner is on Miracles. So, Johnny Turbo thinks it's Mono Black Devotion. Maybe. Maybe he's playing Grey Merchant in Legacy. I have no idea. It's weird to think that I kind of miss Grey Merchant of Asphodel because I hated... Well... I guess that wasn't the card I hated in the deck so much last year. It was really Packrat, but what can you do? I'd be kind of interested to see if Nathan does well tonight, because I kind of like Rug Delver, and I hope it still is a good deck. I'm not totally convinced from the few results of Star Cities so far if whether or not it is or isn't good anymore. It might just be that the other fair decks are just like too good against it at this point. There's just too many good cards against them, but we'll see. Mark also might be able to confirm upstairs what mono black is entailing, so we'll see. Sanctuary asked in the chat, what's the point of Piranha Marsh, I think? And that's just the funny kill condition that Mark wants Kyle to play in his World Gorger Dragon deck, but we'll see. Johnny Turbo asks, does Legacy Delver run Dig now? It's very hard to say whether or not it does or doesn't. I think Dig belongs in Blue-White-Red Delver, but it doesn't belong in Rug Delver. Probably it does not belong in Bug Delver either, because Rug and Bug don't have the really high power single threats to get off of Dig to really make it worth it, rather than just like playing another cantrip that, you know, doesn't ever get stuck in your hand early on in the game. But Blue White Red Delver, you can Dig and you can get a True Name and a Jitte maybe, or True Name and some other equipment, where it, you know, that's a super powerful two cards to get off of Dig. Where Rug Delver, what are you going to do? You going to get two Tarmogoyfs? I don't know. We'll see, though. I mean, I think being the fair deck... Hey, can you guys hear us? It just went out. Yeah, that matchup seemed atrocious. Can everyone hear me now? The stream just cut out for a sec. Just tell me in the chat if it's back. Evan, I see it says offline there. It's telling me it's online now, but it could be wrong. Air Tony confirms, damn you Comcast, I agree. Can you guys tell me if it's coming back now? It seems, okay, it's back, good. Yeah, it just cut out for a second there.
What happened?
The stream cut out for like 10 seconds.
Oh.
Then it went back in.
Did it? Okay.
Did you hear about what is happening upstairs? What is Bob playing? It just says mono black.
We're putting Bob on camera.
Okay.
It is.
Did he lose?
No, he's up a game against Tony, but okay. But he's at the moment hellbent, and Tony has an active Jace.
Oh, it looks like they're going to game three.
No, this. Well, yeah, this is. This
Who's
is not
this?
Them, but.
Oh.
And somebody didn't reset the stream, Greg.
Oh yeah, I didn't do anything.
Yeah, it's Maverick versus Sneak and Show here.
Oh, I see.
So
wait, what's in his deck? Smallpox?
Oh, I saw there was Grey Merchant.
Okay.
Gatekeeper Malachar.
Oh my god.
Phyrexian Arena. I looked down, I was like, oh, are you guys already done? Are you guys playing Tiny Leaders right now? Nope. Oh, it made me so happy. Alright. All right, so we got Greg Pino versus Kyle Haltman.
Yeah.
Mr. Kyle Haltman apparently got knocked out by Chapin, excuse me, but it got a pen.
Yeah.
Yeah, courtesy pen.
When you play against a Hall of Famer, you get a trinket.
You get a trinket.
Yeah.
It's like here, you just got wrecked. Although he did say he took one game, right?
I think he took game one. They give it to you whether or not you beat them.
Sure. But, I mean, it's just, yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, Kyle took one game, and then Chapin complimented him on his play of game one.
Yes.
And then Kyle just decided to start smashing his head against the playmat.
He may not have played terribly well in games two and three.
That is what he said, yeah.
Apparently, Petrunkin has a Legacy podcast.
Yo, Wilson, get your shit together, all right? Are you guys hyping us? Hype us, we'll hype you. The Brainstorm Show? That's a terrible name, Wilson.
That's not nice.
I'll listen to it tomorrow. Our name is Wooberg, doesn't matter, all right? Ours is like a guttural noise.
Yeah.
Have you seen Silicon Valley? If not, we got to watch it sometime.
Okay.
But basically, they're like, a name's got to be something you just scream while you're having sex. So Wooberg, that's something that you would do. The Brainstorm Show is not. That's gone on way too long. All right, just putting it out there.
Sounds good.
It's not really Gate because it uses Bob, not Arena. Come on, Greg. Get your dice game going. Yeah. Well, Wilson, I hope you're well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gatekeeper.
Gatekeeper of Malachi?
They're talking about the gate. Right?
I don't know.
They said, oh my god, the gate.
Screaming Wooberg is not actually something I would do. Kron, that's fair. That's completely fair.
It doesn't have to be for everyone.
it's
It's more like for anyone.
It's a lifestyle. All right? Yeah. Oh my
this is a pithing needle, presumably on sneak attack.
Yes. I have to imagine. I don't know what else you're calling, unless maybe you're going after a fetch. yeah. But
you can say scalding tarn, but it's not worth it.
I choose not to respond to Mark, so he comes across as a bad guy. That's smart. Yeah. Smart. Oh, it's sneak attack. Thank you, Greg.
Yep.
It's to be. Depends on what your definition of way too long is. Am I right?
Right.
Eh? I like it.
He took the piece of paper away.
That's fine.
Fine.
They're
in game three?
Yes. Okay. They're in game three. Greg had a sword of fire and ice on a scavenging use.
That's cool.
Let's actually bring up something relevant here. Let's
what, pithing needle?
Nah, sneak attack. That he can't, that does nothing now. But yeah. It's still something relevant to the match.
Sure. Looks like Kyle's looking at pyroclasm in his hand as well, which should be buying him quite a bit of time. Looks like he also has Blood Moon, actually. I think he might try to jam it next turn, because he can fetch another island with his Scalding Tarn and then have Volcanic for a red producer. So turn three, we might be looking at a Blood Moon here.
He did have Blood Moon in the game that I saw that was right up there. Yeah.
Although, I don't know if he kept it in his hand there and might have shuffled it away, because, I mean, Pino already has a Forest, so if he has a Plains next turn, then Blood Moon's pretty ineffectual.
Yeah.
Of course, it does turn off like Caracas, which is one of Pino's best ways of interacting with Kyle.
Certainly.
But still. Yeah, I don't see the Blood Moon in his hand anymore. This is a pithing needle right back. I wonder if he's naming Caracas.
Just Pino immediately regretting the fact that he wrote so large.
Yeah, this is
all right. Caracas. So it is on Caracas. Okay. Let's bring up Caracas since everybody's talking about it. Okay, Caracas. And so Dice Dojo, it's always been Chicagoland Games Dice Dojo, but they just go by Dice Dojo for brevity's sake, I guess.
Looks like Kyle has a Show and Tell and Grizzlebrand in his hand, so he might go for it right here.
That seems good.
It does.
Especially since that Pithing Needle is on Caracas.
Oh, boy. Blip, blip, blip,
blip, blip. That's Containment Priest. We'll bring that
really
up.
That's good. No force of will. Kyle's putting a land into play.
Wow. That's rough. What is Greg putting into play? Probably a Wasteland, yeah?
Looks like it. Just ramping him. That was a pretty big blowout.
And that's what we call a shitty explorer. So we got Containment Priest up here. We'll bring up a Show and Tell now to try to give you guys an idea as to why it was bad.
Containment Priest is awesome.
Yeah. So...
it is so good against Show and Tell.
Alright, let's see. Dice Dojo is near... The first Dice Dojo store is actually near a martial arts studio. Correct.
Yeah, it's next door still.
Yeah. Clayton Clay Davis is asking a lot of questions. Thank you everybody in chat for helping him out. Appreciate it. yeah, Kais Chothroff. I mean, you gotta... I don't know. Talk to your wife. That's what I did. The comment was, whenever I yell Wooberg, my wife kicks me out of the bedroom. My wife tried that. I said, nope, this is me now. Enjoy it. And then she's hit me. Because she's very abusive.
That sounds bad.
Yeah. So what's Kyle's out here to Containment Priest? Like
he has Pyroclasm in his hand.
Oh, okay. So that's an out.
Yeah, I don't know if Pino's going to commit anything more to the board.
Do we miss a hit?
Ooh,
from...
there's a Caracas. That's really good.
But, I mean, there's pithing on Caracas.
I mean, it still taps for
a
while.
Do we miss a hit from Containment Priest?
I don't think so.
Okay.
And, yep, this is a knight and a waste.
All right, so knight's a 4-4.
4-4, yeah. Pyroclasm, not going to do enough. I mean, it deals with the priest, which is something.
Yeah, and Kyle has another Show and Tell.
Yeah, he has Show and Tell plus Grizzlebrand in hand. If he had had the...
Greg's got another Containment Priest, though.
Jeez.
So as long as he doesn't tap out, he's fine. Which I don't think Greg's going to do.
No, he won't. He's floating mana here with Knight.
Yeah. So we'll bring him Knight of the Will Inquiry.
He's growing a lot on the Knight now. Pino fetching away.
Knight. Reliquary. Yeah. And he fetched?
Yeah, he's at 18. So okay. He just turboed up his knight right there.
So knight's a 6-6 right now? Is that what I'm saying?
It looks like it. Yep. And this is a green sun for a Rex Sage.
Oh, wow.
This...
All right.
I mean, he can put Grizzlebrand into play here.
He can, but...
And draw 7, at least.
Yeah, he's going to draw 7, but then he's almost going to be lethal to what's on board.
This is true.
If he does that, like...
Yep. Well, he might draw 7, try to hit Lotus Petal plus Pithing Needle.
Sure. Okay, so Greg's going to put in Stoneforge Mystic off the show until he's going to go get an equipment. I have to imagine it's probably a sort of Fire and Ice.
Yeah.
I
think Kyle's going to have to take some risks right here. He has not played a land yet, notably.
Wilson trolling. Wants a rundown of how to play Mud because they heard I'm an expert at playing bad decks.
Yeah.
It's true. It's true.
100%. Oh, he did not draw 7.
That's interesting. Maybe he'll draw 7 in response?
That doesn't do anything, though. Isn't he just dead now?
I think he is. Yeah, like, that seems
6,
weird.
7, 8, 9. Oh, he'll go to 1. Unless there's a fetch.
Well, fetch or Wastelander I could have.
Yeah.
Doesn't look like he has either.
No.
But
so Kyle just let it happen. I don't know what he was thinking was there exactly.
So, if I'm Greg, I just leave up the 2 mana for Containment Priest.
Right.
Swing in with Knight right. And Rex Sage.
I think...
And then, because then, like, worst case, if by leaving the 2 mana up, he can also activate Stoneforge Mystic if nothing else happens that he has to do. Yeah. So he just swings and we're...
Yep.
So he's taking 8 there?
He's at
right?
9. Yep.
All right. All right. There you go.
Looks like he drew Lotus Petal.
Is that going to be good enough?
Why not?
Yeah, I mean, the Pyroclasm is doing nothing.
Yeah. I think he had to... draw 7 last turn and try to hit Pithing Needle for Caracas. Because I think he has multiple needles in his deck. It's not just the one that got blown up by Rex Sage. I would have to imagine he has 2 or 3 in the deck. I could be wrong about that. That would make sense that he didn't draw 7 if that's the case.
Yeah.
Although, I don't know what the point of show and telling that turn is if he wasn't planning on doing anything.
Yeah, drawing the 7. I agree with that. And I mean, as I prefer Bagels points out, drawing 7 is just a bad ability.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't typically want that to happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cards that draw 7 have never been playable.
No. It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
Peblica TV, hello. How are you doing? Let's see. Not Mud. True Not Mud. He plays Blue Jank Mud. Not True Mud. No, I play True Mud. And Blue Jank Mud.
Blue Mud
depending.
Was once.
Yeah, I played, well, twice.
It's one time.
One time on camera, several months ago.
This is,
and, like, by several months, I mean, like, a year. Yeah, that's
Kyle
that's
goes for Pyroclasm. In response, Pino flashes in Store to Fire and Ice, which is going to get equipped to the surviving knight.
And be lethal.
Yeah, very lethal.
All right, so we'll bring it back. I don't think we're going to get anybody. I'll go run up unless you want to run up.
No, you can.
All right.
You went last time, actually. I'll go.
Sure?
Yeah, you talk to your people.
And tell tell Bob that we're getting him on camera, just because. I'm pulling weight here. Yeah. Pulling rank. That's what's going on. All right, guys, I'm going to go back through chat really quick. I love Maverick. Something about Tutu's beating... out Eldrazi. It's very nice to see. It is very nice. Let's see. I think I answered most of that. Bop, 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 bop. Yep, this is the Dice Dojo in the north. Do you deck faster Heplin Mill strats out? No idea what this is a reference to. Pino Grigio, yes. Pakum Runkin, that's a pretty janky name, I agree. Get Mono Black, please. That's what we're doing. Wilson, tell us about your podcast. I'm willing to rep you. Just throw some love our way. It's on SoundCloud. Send me, PM me a link, either on Facebook or here. And, or if you guys have a YouTube page, you can do that as well. And I'll get you guys up there. So, that'll be good. Boomchild, how you doing? The draw is 7 minutes. Yes. Yeah, I know. Saxel, I missed your goofy name as well. I'm happy to be back. Work's a little bit, I'm not working, you know, like 80-hour work weeks, so I got a little bit more time. So it'll be good. I'm still like a million years behind on getting all the giveaways shipped out. So anybody that has a giveaway, again, I apologize. I've been super busy for like the past month. And I think like 3 weeks behind on mailing stuff out. So again, I really apologize, guys. I went and bought a bunch of envelopes. Now I just got to address everything. And I'll probably get that going tomorrow. Yeah. So then Wednesday, they'll probably be shipped out. I know I keep saying that. Again, I don't want to 100% promise anything, but I will get everything out. I've got all the cards cataloged. I've got all the t-shirts cataloged. So they will be getting there, including the guy that's in Belgium. They got a shirt. Going to figure that out. So Pat Runke, the first podcast was very general, but we're posting one tonight and how to play with and against Storm. We have a third. Oh, you have Mr. Braverman? I want Braverman and Silverman to get together. It would be beautiful. We had the man group. So I was on the, saw you guys have articles. So Elf Attacker, basically I had a few more people helping me out with the website when we first started. And we were trying to push content and pushing that a little bit more. As it's kind of shaken out, it's pretty much me doing everything now. I'm very, very lucky to have people volunteer to cast with me, which is absolutely amazing, which is a time sink and stuff. But also keeping up the website and everything else. At some point, once I get a little bit more help or I have more free time, I do want to go back to doing that and curating everything. It just kind of got a little bit too much to handle, so I'm really using the website as you can see, like the landing page, like the homepage is just basically a giant link board now. And that's kind of what I'm keeping it for the time being. Until I have, again, time to go back and actually start building that stuff out and getting more articles. Of course, now we've got much more of a follower base, so we'll probably be able to source articles a lot more easier. So that's something that I'll talk to Mr. Schaefer. He likes reading, and see if we can kind of push that a little further. Let's see. What else we ended through? Nasty love for you in our Facebook group. Okay, good. Just build dick pics modern. I agree. I have a giveaway chiasm. Okay, I actually already followed you guys. Yes, TPS. Now everybody's just kind of stroking off Wilson. That's fair. Lord of the Pit, greater than Girls of Brand, comes out of turn earlier. Johnny Turbo, I agree. Whoa, second hand. Sauce and Indy never came up because I'm not a pro. Hey, I day-2'd and was on my way to be top 16. And then a fucking storm had to come through. And I was like, unless I get top 16, it is not worth me having to crash here another night. So we kind of left it there. I want to see Lord of Pit and Legacy. Unfortunately, Evan, you're probably never going to see that. Yep, I'll be honest there. Well, if you need a writer, once you get back, put it. Yeah, we actually, and I've had a couple people send me articles, and I feel really bad that I have not gotten them up on the site, because they're really good. So, do you guys take article submissions? Yeah, we do, and actually, that's what I was just saying. A couple people have sent me article submissions, and they're actually well written, and I just need to get them up. It's just a matter of, again, kind of getting the time to actually put all that stuff up.
I have bad news.
Listen. What?
Looks like Bob is going to lose.
I don't care. Still yeah. Putting him on. That's pretty good. BJ Dennis and my hero Mud. That's right. Play the deck Maple Swarm. Yep. And Chapter. Hi. How you doing? I want to see 12 posts. We don't have 12 posts today.
No 12 posts.
And if I'm actually playing and you see me playing Mud, mm-hmm. Still won't see any goddamn posts.
Because right.
Fuck tap lands. Okay. You have 1 to 4 lands that do jack shit and come into play tapped. Then you got 4 more lands that come into play tapped that don't do anything for you turn one, so you can't even shit anything else out. I don't know. I'm not a fan of the post base. Just saying.
Mark's a big fan of shitting, though.
Oh, I love some shitting. Yeah. I love some shitting stuff out on turn one. That is what I strive for.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm like, you know what? Can I shit this out on turn one? No? Bad card. That's what I play. I play 60 cards, all of them one drops.
Yep.
No lands.
And a bunch of steel Hellkites. Because why?
Oh, yeah, why not? I love steel Hellkite.
Oh, God.
It's good things. No post and mud, not scrub. Not scrub.
I don't think we have any Jund in Legacy. Thank God.
Bogner's here.
Yeah.
Is he playing Miracles? Okay, yeah, he's on Miracles Jund tonight. Sucks. Five color loam, please. Maybe. Sounds like I should be playing Vintage Mud. I would love to.
The cards that I saw in the mono black deck included Gatekeeper of Malakir, Liliana of the Veil, Gray Merchant.
Gray Merchant. Yeah, I saw Phyrexian Arena.
Phyrexian Arena. I don't know what he has.
There's got to be a Vampire Hexmage.
I have
in
no
there.
Idea what he has at 1 and 2 mana. I didn't see anything.
It's got to be a Vampire Hexmage, right?
He was looking in his hand, and it was like a bunch of 3 and 5 drops, and he was facing down a True Name and a Vendilion Click.
I saw Toxic Deluge.
Okay, that would help.
Yeah. In the games. I have to imagine he's running like Dark Ritual.
I would imagine right? He's playing like Smallpox. But yeah, Dark Rit probably.
The game that I also saw, he had 12 lands out. So okay. I think he flooded game 2 real bad.
I mean, the game lasted a long time. It's just...
Yeah.
He has... The problem with... Like, he has all these lands that all they do are tap for black. And like, he doesn't have like many utility lands past like Wasteland.
I'd probably go like full...
He can't afford to have, like, Mutavaults and...
But you could go, like, 3 or 4 Urborg, and then, like... Okay. And
if
then
he plays
just kind of go for it.
It's risky, like, if he either draws a bunch of Urborgs, or if he draws a bunch of Mishra's Factories and no Urborg, and
doesn't,
then he can't
even,
cast
even
any...
Even still, then he's still swinging. Like, I don't know.
He's swinging, but, like, if they have a Batterskull, they're not swinging.
Yeah, I guess, like, yeah... When you've got, when you're trying to cast Great Gatekeeper Malakir.
Yeah, it definitely constrains what
he's
you can
do. He's gotta have Dark Ritual, right? Like...
I don't know.
Did you see a Phyrexian Obliterator? I hope so.
You have to assume that's there. I don't know why you'd bother.
Turn 4 Phyrexian Obliterator, turn 5 Grey Merchant, boom!
Boom.
Boom!
Yep.
I like it.
You definitely did not die to an Emrakul already attacking you.
Alright, no, so, alright, here, turn one, alright, here we go.
Okay.
You're playing against Show and Tell.
Okay.
Okay. They go ham, alright, they Show and Tell in.
Yeah, you put Liliana into play and you get him.
You can't put Liliana into play off of Show and Tell, get together. No, it's a Planeswalker.
Oh, it's not called out on the card?
Yeah. Oh my God, Greg.
It says specifically,
You're like a guy, all right, that I called because he put a fucking Nicol Bolas in play off of a Show and Tell, and I was like, you can't do that. Judge, get over here. Get over here. Yeah, this guy.
That's dumb.
This is what you get for playing little white creatures. Yeah. All right? Because the laundry list.
Yeah, it calls out.
No, so he goes, okay, whatever. Emrakul, okay. Then he puts in land,
okay.
All right? And then he goes, Dark Ritual, Gatekeeper Malakir.
Okay.
Bam. All right. Done.
Yeah.
That's taken care of.
Definitely did not get countered.
No, didn't get countered. All right. And then pass the turn back.
Okay.
Okay. Plays another land. So now he's got 3 lands. All right.
Yeah.
He goes Dark Ritual again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now he's got access to, what, 5 mana?
Yeah. No cards in hand because he's played 2 Dark Rituals.
Now he's got plenty of cards in hand.
Okay.
I'm not.
I guess you keep the Dark Ritual.
Yeah, I don't know.
He's probably playing Pack Rat.
I don't know. He seemed to have gotten... He got game 1 pretty quick against Tony.
Yeah.
So, like...
I don't know.
There's
anything.
Am I wrong to prefer Abyssal Persecutor? No.
Eh.
I mean, it's like, yeah.
I think I'd rather have Desecration Demon.
Yeah.
I think.
Ooh, I would love to see some Dash Hopes. Dash Hopes is not bad. Dash Hopes is take a Lava Axe to the face for 2 black.
What's the other choice?
Get to a spell countered.
Oh, yeah, Kyle talked about that upstairs.
Which
it's
one?
Like, he told Bob that he should have had Dash Hopes in his hand.
Oh.
That was a nice thing for him to tell Bob while he was getting his face crushed.
Ooh! And any player can do this. So you're running, what's the 13, 13? Death Shadow. You're running Death Shadow, so you can cast it, and then you pay it yourself.
This card's terrible.
No.
It's so bad.
No, it's really good.
It seems horrific, but...
You could stifle that trigger.
Okay.
Then you're playing blue.
Your deck's probably better because you're playing blue.
Yeah, Rit, Forest, Pangelica Worm. I like it.
Okay.
I like Dash Hopes.
Yep.
Because it's probably going to be a Lava Axe.
It's going to be a Lava Axe unless a Lava Axe is better for them. Like, that's the problem with Punisher
cards.
Well,
no. I think, like, if you put Dash Hopes in your deck, then you just assume it's always going to be a Lava Axe against your opponent.
Okay, but then what are the other cards in your deck, like, that make Lava Axe relevant?
I don't know. Maybe Bloodghast and some Bloodsoak Champions and some Gravecrawlers. Okay. And so you're just going, like, and it's just a big black burn spell.
Okay. Yeah, it probably belongs in, like...
Until they just say,
Suicide
okay,
Black,
countered
I
spell.
Suppose.
And then they just, like, okay, you can counter that spell.
Yeah. Suicide Black.
I don't know.
All right.
Just putting it out there. It's good. Real players play Temporal Extortion. Maybe. Market is one of the... Is one of the people who also think Lifelink... Oh, Life Force is a good card. I know I've heard of it, but let me see.
Peb in the chat's talking, comparing it to Vexing Devil.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Destroy... Yeah. That is Banecast. Yeah, no. No, Life Force is bad.
Why?
Huh?
What does it do?
It's green, counter to target black spell. Enchantment.
Perfect.
Oh, but if Simon had had this, if okay. Simon had had this against Kyle, it would have been nuts.
Until it got bounced.
No, you counter it, you make it black. You're playing Painter Servant too.
Okay.
Everything's black. Broke the meta.
Yeah, this is...
Mono Green Painter Servant.
Yeah, Mono Green Painter with Life Force. That's what it should be.
Oh my god. So good. So, so good.
So something.
Cook, I'm doing great. I'm glad to see you. I haven't been here in forever. Do we know? Did you tell Bob he's getting on?
No.
No, my God.
He was playing. I wasn't sure if you're gonna want to put him on camera because he was losing. Oh God. Petrunk and Mark might talk about Browbeat. Let's not bring it up to him though, because I don't want to hear it. Oh boy. Yep. The black set. It's talking about Painter Servant on green, and then you can natural order for Iona. That is the lock. Sorry.
Everybody was sitting down.
Sorry.
and it's going to be great, because your call of, okay, I have an Emrakul, what do you do now? We're going to get to see that.
What?
He's playing Get Show and Tell.
Perfect. Which was
all right. We're gonna take our pretty faces off. Why couldn't fucking Kyle sit on the same side he was sitting on before?
I don't know. Just to screw with you.
I know. Apparently. We're gonna go ahead and start the timer.
Yep.
Looking good there.
These players are in the 0-1 bracket, I believe.
Yeah, they are. All right. So speak. You guys, everybody can blame me. I'm perfectly happy with being blamed if this is just miserable to watch. Kyle Heltman. Then we got Mr. Bob Agra.
Boba.
Good show. Mono, black, goodness. Can you think of a better name?
We'll think of a better name.
All right. I gotta get something in there, though.
Should call it Suicide Bob instead of Suicide Black.
No, but there's Bob, but there's like actual like cards that could be Bob.
Yeah, but his name is Bob. His name is Bob.
Yeah.
And yeah, Suicide Black is a deck.
You just want to do Suicide Bob?
I think it's better than Mono B goodness.
Alright, we can do that. That's fine. I'll secede to that. Let's see.
Bob's also playing a deck that's likely going to mean he's going to die a lot.
Suicide Bob.
Nice.
All right, got it. So what do we see in his hand? Oh, so there is a Phyrexian Obliterator.
See Thoughtseize,
Gatekeeper Malakir. All right.
Gatekeeper, Lily, yep. Thoughtseize. It's a fine it's a hand Phyrexian against.
Oh, look, I didn't even need to adjust Kyle's life total there.
You did not.
Nope, that's great.
That's great.
Planned it.
Match record.
Oh, yep, very good point, very good point.
Kyle reading. Oh, it does have two Urborgs.
All right, so maybe he does have. Maybe I just saw, like, the 12 swamps that he has.
Maybe.
Out.
I think.
Yeah, so this is a little awkward.
I mean, he can lead Thoughtseize. Hopefully, he draws a two-mana play. He doesn't want to run out Gatekeeper. Well, he might actually, in this matchup, just run it out.
Yeah, as soon as it show and tells something.
Yeah, because he also has the Lily, so he has a redundant.
Obliterator's pretty interesting, though.
Against what?
Against Kyle.
How so?
Well, I guess not. I guess it's just never going to be blocked. So yes. Never mind. We'll bring it up, because that's something to bring up that's relevant.
He did draw Cabal Therapy, though, which is going to be a great follow-up to Thoughtseize.
Yes, it will be. What am I doing?
Everyone's asking what land that is. He has Urborg. He also has...
Phyrexia's Tower.
Yeah, Phyrexia's Tower. Or Phyrexian Tower.
Yeah, Phyrexian...
There's a lot of Phyrexian.
Tower. Yep. There we go. Sacrifice a creature. Add black to your mana pool.
Why not?
It's a good thing.
It has really good art.
And so we did see a Thoughtseize come down. What was taken? Fluster? Or
I think it was... Oh, he got Flusterstormed.
Got Flusterstormed. Okay, sure. Bob's at 18. Oh, no, he's not going to be at 18 because it got countered.
Nope.
Never mind.
He might run Lake of the Dead Petrunken. I'm not sure. That would be cool, though.
You have to.
Pull up Lake of the Dead.
Yeah. And Brain's 468. Thank you for following. Much appreciated.
Lake of the Dead does have sick art.
And it's a cool card.
Yes.
This is a cool card in general.
Oh, that's sick art.
Yeah. I used to have some of those.
Totally. I mean, I don't think they're worth anything.
No, they're not. They're worth just jack shit. So Brainstorm by Kyle on his right. turn.
So he is playing man lands. That's Immutavolt. Not sure.
Do you just blind...
Cabal Therapy?
Blind Cabal Therapy, yeah.
I think he has to.
Oh, because then he can play man. He can play the Immutavolt and flash it back.
He already played a land this turn.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did. This is his
yes,
second,
he did. Shut up,
it's
Greg.
His second turn.
You don't know.
I think he just named Show and Tell in the dark.
Yeah.
Which looks like that's what he did.
So
I mean, this hand's not that bad.
No, it's not. And okay, so I was expecting a lot.
Yeah,
a lot worse.
It's not that bad for Bob. Is what I should say.
All right, and okay, yeah. I mean, why the hell not? BJ Dennis, thank you for being here. Much appreciated. Phyrexia Tower, does he run Lake of the Dead? Yeah, I hope so. Was that an egg? No, it wasn't. I remember when Lake of the Dead was like $14. That was a long time ago.
Yep.
That
was when Necropotence was a card.
Yes.
In standard, or the equivalent. Type 2.
I like it. All right.
Second hand.
I mean, so far, though, Bob, this is not the worst thing.
He's keeping pace.
Yeah, so he just plays Liliana now.
Probably.
Oh, he just play Liliana.
Well,
take up,
the
pass,
problem
right?
with Liliana is it's vulnerable to sneak attack.
Oh, and the spell pierce.
Oh, sure.
And
does
the spell pierce.
Does he know about that?
Yeah, he just saw the spell pierce.
I mean, you could play Gatekeeper flashback Cabal Therapy if you really want. He might be animating Mutavault and flashing back therapy. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
What is he going after?
He's got to sneak it. He's got a show and tell now,
yeah.
though.
He doesn't have a creature, though. Yeah. It doesn't seem like right.
Billy the Cool Kid, thank you for following.
He might be taking Dig.
Yeah.
Or sneak attack.
Yeah.
Dig.
Okay. I probably would have taken sneak attack.
I don't hate taking Dig.
Yeah, but sneak attack's one of the things that like Bob's going to have the hardest time interacting with.
Well, maybe. I mean, Kyle's missing quite a bit. He needs a creature. He also needs more lands. Bob not running out the Gatekeeper. I might have just played it as a 2-2 because he does need to apply a clock.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, which is actually a very good point. Because if he just sits there and just starts whittling away.
He got rid of the Mutavault, too. It's like... now he also doesn't have a third land that sticks around, because like he has Liliana next turn, but he knows about Spell Pierce, which is the problem.
Yeah.
Now this is a show and tell, probably putting in Sneak Attack.
Gibbonson, no, no, I don't believe there is Death Shadow in the deck. It's just kind of funny, because Bob's probably going to not do as well as he would like tonight. That was Greg's joke. I prefer bagels, thank you for following. I think that followed. It's so hard. I can't.
Ooh, that's a quick Phyrexian Obliterator.
All right, so that's the clock you were looking for.
If he can,
oh!
Therapy was a good draw.
All right, so
I think he could also just jam Liliana.
Yeah, jam Liliana, tick up, pitch the other Urborg.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Well, definitely attacking for five at some point.
Nope, just doesn't attack. Just forgets.
He's just not sure whether he wants to therapy or Liliana.
And Kyle's actually at 16.
Okay.
And I imagine he's going to be at 11, right? Yep, but looks like he just took the life, so.
So he's Cabal therapying.
Naming.
Probably, well, what did he see last turn? Did he see Force of Will last turn?
Yeah, no, Force of Will's been in the hand for a long time.
So he might just force this.
Yeah.
To hide whatever the last card is.
Echoing Truth? Is that the one that he's
hiding?
Yeah.
Potentially.
But I think, no, Bob knows about the Echoing Truth, though.
I'm not sure which he didn't know about there. Now he has a kind of awkward spot, because now he's, you know, spent his whole turn sort of doing this. He could also just play Gatekeeper and sack it to Therapy, which... Okay.
Play the Liliana.
Did he not even attack with it?
No, he attacked with the Phyrexian Obliterator. So
he's very intent on just emptying Kyle's hand. The problem is he has Sneak Attack in play. Like,
yeah,
any Emrakul off the top is horrific for Bob.
I agree. I much rather have left the clock.
And now he's also... He doesn't have any creature in play to attack with.
Yeah.
Like, he got rid of the Mutavault and... Yeah. I think I would have... If he really wanted to make him discard something, he could have just played the Gatekeeper and gotten rid of... Like...
Yeah.
What is... Like, Gatekeeper's sacrifice effect is not doing anything here.
No, and especially with Sneak Attack. Once he played Sneak Attack, the Gatekeeper is just miserable.
Yeah, it's like a
just
pipe
bad.
Dream, right?
Yeah. Well, there's
a Nighthawk?
Yeah, Vampire...
probably the best draw possible.
Yeah.
Just play Nighthawk and...
Discard the Gatekeeper. Gatekeeper's just bad. I mean, like...
Yeah, I don't know why he's... He seems to be valuing it very highly.
Gatekeeper will never be... Okay, there he's pitching. Yeah. So it looks like he might have a response. There's an Echoing Truth, sure. Okay, so... Ooh, nope.
So now he just replays Lily.
Probably, right? Or no,
Kyle
maybe
has
you
no
want.
Hand,
you
right?
want. Yeah, you have no hands, so get the Nighthawk in play. Right? Get
yeah,
the Nighthawk in
this
play.
Turn, yeah, you're right.
And that way.
So next turn
you have an attacker, yeah.
Yeah, next turn you just tick Lily up.
Yeah. So we'll bring up Nighthawk.
It's cool art on Vampire Nighthawk. This
That's the
like
promo
it might be
one.
A sneak attack activation.
Oh, blah.
Oh, boy. He is drawing seven.
Yeah. So he's going down to two here. Well, yep. I mean, he's going to attack, so.
Yeah. The question is, does he find Red Source plus Emrakul?
Yeah. Here, we'll bring up the addition that, actually, can you see the promo ones? I don't know. I don't think you can see the promo ones. The promo art.
Oh, no.
Guess not.
It's like an FNM art, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
Yep.
Polish guy, thank you for following.
There's another red source. Is this? Nope.
No?
Ponder.
All right.
There's Emrakul.
Oh, but he doesn't have another red source.
He has the Lotus Petal in that Ponder.
I don't.
If he has Probe, he can find. Oh, no, he can't pay the two life.
Yeah, he can't pay the two life. So he just can't.
Not this turn. It's not the end of the world, though.
No.
He just keeps. Like,
yeah, so
you just keep the Emrakul on the top of your deck with the Ponder and get him next turn.
Yeah, so we're here at 13.
Yep. Goes up to 9.
Yeah. See, and like if Bob didn't throw away the... Yeah, if Bob didn't throw away the Frexian Obliterator, this would be...
Yeah, he might have been able to erase it.
Yeah. Because even if he plays Liliana here...
Doesn't matter.
He can only go up to 15 with the Nighthawk.
Did not attack with Nighthawk.
Yeah, I mean, none of this...
Yeah. Yep. Kyle has wisely kept Emrakul on the top of his deck.
Yeah.
He'll probably just flip it over.
Yeah, this is...
Bob just double-checking what's in his hand.
Yeah. So, this is unfortunate because Bob, I think, could have gotten this game.
Yeah. I think he just had to press his advantage harder and go less... for less control, like pure control of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. All right.
That is sneak attack.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, I agree. If he had gotten the... Because there were a couple of turns he could have played Gatekeeper Malakir after the Sneak and Show was already out.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're just... Yeah, you just want to be... You just want to start getting aggressive and you don't, like... Once Sneak Attack's out, Gatekeeper Malakir is terrible. Gatekeeper Malakir is awesome if you think that he's just going to show and tell in something and then pass the turn back to you and then you get to make him sack it.
Yeah, but that's sort of like... They have to, like, whiff on a lot of other things they could have there for that to actually work.
Yeah.
Because, like, they have to not have a force of will to and just counter the Gatekeeper.
I thought he bounced in response to the trigger. He probably did. All right, let's read this really quick.
Yeah, he bounced in response to the Liliana activation.
Spicy Meatball, you're not man enough for mud. I agree. Whoever said BJ Dennis, you're right. I trust your opinion. Disappointing. I prefer donuts. Donuts are quite good. Bagels have a place, though. Bagels have a place.
They do.
And all right, what? Hard in the paint, so he just draws Ember. Yeah, Sir Cucumber, he pretty much had it right. I feel Bob misplayed seriously there. Yes, Gibson, we agree. That's insane. That's why it's called Suicide Bob. Yes. But I think Bob also realizes that this is kind of just a fun deck. Bob is also the guy that played Squirrels.
Yes.
Just
because it's a fun deck doesn't mean you don't want to try to win with it, though.
No, I agree. Yeah.
Like, he kind of had the tools there. Discard is really good against Show and Tell.
Yeah, not on Gather, I think. You can see promos, it's fine. Yeah, but unfortunately, I don't know. Maybe I'll start using magiccards.info. Bouncer and Despise the Truth. Yeah, he wouldn't be able to pay for that. Oh, that's a very good point. If he had gotten one attack in.
Yeah, he wouldn't have been able to Grizzlebrand Grizzlebrand.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. All right.
The damage does really, really matter against Show and Tell.
It doesn't matter. Your creature's going to die. You tag with it. Can you show us Gatekeeper? Yes, sorry. We were talking about it the whole time, and we just did not bring it up. Gatekeeper Malakir. Here we go, guys. It's black for a 2/2 with a kicker of black. When you pay it, target player has to sacrifice a creature. So it does good things.
Doesn't do anything if it is just Show and Tell them to play, though.
Yeah. Graysickle, it is a beautiful voice, and I'm glad that you missed it. But I'm here tonight, and I'll probably be here every Monday from now on. Thursdays is going to be a little hard. But, yeah. Dr. Jerp, Markerstein is here. Squirrels without Earthcraft. Yes, that's true. I mean, Bob did okay with Squirrels one of the times he played it.
It was okay, yeah.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed Flicker Wisping his squirrel nest. That was fun. Or I should say the forest it was on.
Oh, man.
That was great. That was really great.
Yeah.
Flicker Wisp was a fucked up card.
It happens. Yeah. Oh, man. But what?
What?
I have no idea.
Okay.
It's good.
Game 2.
Oh, yeah. I owe you some thigh rubs.
Okay. I'll.
That's what I told you that earlier.
I'll let
today.
You keep them.
You promise?
This looks like a reasonable hand.
Oh, and there's a Grey Merchant. Grey Merchant of Askra.
Looks like it's Thoughtseize, a couple swamps.
Liliana.
Yep.
Kyle's
What's
hand.
That card, that third from the back.
Or is that a Frexy Arena?
Or is that a... That, it's probably Grey Merchant, you're right. Okay.
I thought it was Grey Merchant.
It might not. That actually might be Arena. I'm not totally
either way,
sure
we'll bring up
that.
Phyrexian Arena. Why not? Phyrexian Arena.
Yeah, it might be that.
Yeah.
I love that art. I'm tired, too.
How are you tired? It's round two, Greg. What are you going to be like at round four? I was just yawning because I can. That's what a real man does.
I yawned because you yawned.
Yeah, no. Oh, no, that is Phyrexian Arena. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Mishra's about to get his head chopped off by Gerard.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
It happens.
Did he actually go through with it?
I think he does.
Oh, he just dies?
Yeah, I mean, Mishra dies eventually, yeah.
That's sad.
I don't know, Mishra also ends up with, like, a robot body and stuff, too. Like, there's a lot of things.
Okay.
A lot of things. The lore for Magic is quite interesting, and we just have not done this at all.
The overlay?
Yeah, we... I blame Greg Schaefer.
Yep, my fault.
Is Kyle on a mulligan?
I think
looks
so.
Looks like it. And now another mulligan.
Five.
All right.
Playing against discard, this is definitely in Bob's favor.
All right. Read this comment, Marcus, please. Oof. Can't go with the Marcus, though. I have because Marcus is not my name. I got a personal vendetta. I don't know. I hate it when people
call
me Marcus.
When do you call me my real name?
Huh? Schaefer? Call you Schaefer. You can call me McManus all you want. That's
no,
perfectly fine.
You call me like all bullshit, like crazy
what,
names.
What? When?
I don't know.
Yeah, see, I was like, name a single name that I call you other than Schaefer.
Like Sugar Puff. You call me that all the time.
Oh, okay. All right. So Greg has no idea. You weren't here last Monday, Mark. Yes, I was not. Last Monday, I had a bunch of shit going on, so couldn't really.
Last Monday,
get
we didn't
here.
Have a ton of people either. I think that was the day that it was super cold. I could be wrong about that.
I don't know.
This is a turn one Thoughtseize on Kyle's 5-card hand. I think I would take Ponder, unless the Spell Pierce was going to prove to be particularly effective against my hand.
Well, he's got Duress, too.
Yeah, I think I'd
so
just take Ponder.
Yeah. Ponder, and then next turn hit the Spell Snare. Or the Pierce. Probably the Pierce.
Well, I mean, you would take Dig, but since Pierce is the only thing... Like, he's just going to Pierce it. So I think Kyle would prefer to have Dig.
Arena, yeah, so... this is good. All right, Mark, Pat Runkin, thank you. Mark, I will rub your... Mark, if you read this comment, I will rub your thighs. Thank you. I prefer bagels. I expect you to see you at a tournament sometime soon.
Oh, Dr. Derp will follow this channel.
Yeah, Pat Runkin, too. They both will if we read it.
That's good to know. We definitely... We could use more followers. We could always use more followers.
Yeah, but... Yeah, they've already followed.
Well, maybe they'll unfollow and follow again.
That it hurts us, actually. Jumpy 2K6, thank you for following. Much appreciated. All right, so here we got a Liliana. I don't... Kyle actually might not be able to work his way out of this game.
Yeah. A very early Lily could be...
Yeah.
Two discard spells and two...
And then Phyrexian Arena is probably going to come down next turn.
Yeah.
So, that's kind of rough.
Looking pretty good for Bob here.
Yeah. I don't know. You call me McManus, all dare I mean want? What? Dr. Drip, that doesn't even make sense. Urza's about to have his head chopped off Rod, actually, which Urza back from Phyrexia. Okay. Oh, does it? Oh, fair enough.
Looks like this is... So Kyle discarded a Grizzlebrand to Liliana last turn. This turn, I guess Bob is probably going to slam Phyrexian Arena, discard Nighthawk to the Lily activation.
Yeah. Hope to draw land and then play
Obliterator
next turn.
Right.
Yeah. And Kyle hasn't fetched at all, right?
No, he is not. All right.
Yeah, so Kyle's going to have to do something pretty big, pretty fast.
Well, can he dig right now?
Well, he's fetching.
I think he can.
What if, is it Drowning Sorrow? No, it's not Drowning Sorrow. What's the blue-blue or black-black or blue-black spell? The hybrid spell? Hybrid blue-black, hybrid blue-black? for Camp
Shadow,
Church.
Shadow of Doubt.
Yeah. What if Bob just wants Shadow of Doubt?
With
there's no mana open. But what if he did?
What if he did? What if they were playing Mental Magic? This game would be a lot different.
Oh, man. It would. Well, maybe.
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 All right. This is a dig end of turn. Exiling 5, it looks like.
Yes. Digs on 5. Oh, he's getting rid
he's
of 5.
He's paying 3.
Oh, okay, sure. Crimson Viper, I'm not ignoring you. I'm sorry. I love you very much. Very dear. Landon 96, thank you for following. An Alpha BP. No, I know you followed before. I'm catching on. All right.
Land Jace could be real good here. I think that's what he's going for. Yep. Land Jace.
All right, and then Bob. Well, Bob's still going to be drawing a lot of cards, though.
Right. I mean, it's not great, but it might at least help Kyle to help to keep up. Because he can also hide stuff with the Jace Brainstorm.
Yeah. Why doesn't Bob have Bobs? I agree with that. I completely agree.
He might in the deck somewhere.
Yeah. God damn it. Luxac, Delver, Flip, and Wilson must be talking to each other.
Perfect.
Because another friend. Trolling McTrolls Trolls. Did he fetch again?
He did.
Okay.
He kept a fetch off of the dig through time.
That's what I figured. Yeah, fetch and the Jace.
Mm-hmm. This will be... So he's playing the Lotus Petal. Not certain why. Because if he's brainstorming...
Yeah,
I would want to maybe put it back.
Yeah.
Or rather, keep it in my hand, and that's the thing that gets discarded to Lily.
Yeah. No, I agree, too. I don't think he needs... Maybe to hard cast a Force Will? Like, that's the only thing I can think of.
Well, here, he can leave Sneak Attack on the top of his deck, and then next turn, hope to brainstorm down into a creature.
Sure.
So that's pretty solid.
Akrapurskrin, thank you for following. There's another Phyrexian Arena, and he did draw two cards. Bob's going to go down to 17 off of that trigger.
Yeah.
Is that a Bajookabog? All right.
Yep. So it's good against Dig, but it's a little too late. And it looks like he's holding Arena plus Phyrexian Obliterator.
Yeah.
So he's probably discarding the Arena, the spare Arena.
Yeah.
Kyle discarding.
Yeah, it's too bad that Bajookabog intertapped, because that would have been pretty good.
Well, he also probably should have played the Bog after using the Lily.
Oh, yeah. That too. Tony I 336, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
I think Kyle might brainstorm here. If he hits a creature,
no creature. Show and tell.
He'll probably keep floating the Sneak Attack. He also should remember that it's not Ponder. He can put back the card that was already in his hand.
Yeah. Well, whatever.
I mean,
YOLO.
I suppose.
Oh, it's a wipe away.
Before it can go ultimate.
We're gonna bounce. Gonna do a little bouncy bounce, bounce.
Yes.
Which I think is fine. So Bob's gonna get another 16 off of the Phyrexia Arena trigger. There's another land from Bob. At that point, I guess he does want 5. Mm-hmm. So do you play Liliana or do you play
Obliterator?
Yeah.
Well, he has no cards in hand, Kyle. And he needs get down something to fight the Jace.
Yeah.
Because, like, here is Jace obliged to go after the Obliterator.
Yep.
This does let Kyle at least build up some sort of a hand, which is nice.
And Bob's got a Thoughtseize in hand.
He's playing, he plays out the Sneak Attack. Now he just needs time to get through his deck, basically.
Yeah, Bob going down to 15.
If Bob can play a Threat and the Liliana in the same turn, this can break out of the Jace lock.
He's going to be able to play Liliana, or he's going to be able to play Gatekeeper and,
So two threats?
Yeah.
Well, now he knows that his Jace isn't living, so he can just use it to brainstorm one last time to try to get down into his deck as much as possible.
But from Bob's side, I think that's probably the best thing to do in that situation, right?
Probably.
Yeah. So there's a show and tell. Do we get a creature? No, we got a dig through time, though. That's big.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Does he have a fetch as well? No, a Lotus Petal. Well, that's acceleration for the dig.
Yeah.
If he has the mana, he's going to dig right now, I think.
So cracking the two petals, making two mana. He's going down to 15. Exile.
Yes.
Going down to 15.
And then he exiled four. So he had four mana and four cards in the graveyard. Lotus Petal is basically counts as two mana for Delve spells.
What do we get? What do we get? Is that a Grizzlebrand?
Grizzlebrand. If he gets a Grizzle, yeah, he has Grizzlebrand and Remember Cool and two
Desi.
Manas. Yeah. So that's just game.
Oh, never mind. I was really excited because if he ripped Gary off the top, if Bob rips Gary, Bob wins.
Yeah, he has a lot of devotion.
well, he's got. Well, actually, this is interesting.
Why?
Because they both have flying, and he can't do anything about it.
Okay.
That's
so it's not interesting.
Oh, God. He's
like, sack all of his permanents.
Well, no, he had six lands, so he could have left the threats in play.
Okay.
But there was he couldn't block anything. So.
Yeah.
All right, we'll bring you back to the booth. Greg is looking, trying to find something in his lap.
Yep.
I am. You guys can figure out what that is that he's trying to find. Marianne, if you're in chat, chime in.
I don't think she is.
All right, do you want to go try to find another match, or do you want me to?
I can go.
All right. And then we'll actually get a winning match on next camera. Okay. So, next camera!
Next round.
Yep, so I'll go ahead and leave this up here. For the moment, Kyle did take that down. It was good, thanks. All right, so let's see. Mardu Shadowsphere. No. Let's see. Is Bob's shirt a Pokemon shirt? I believe it is. Hashtag I Wumpus 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 Jiggerburgerbrag. I agree. You no longer have. It's too late. I've disowned you. Oh, Crimson. I'm sorry, Crimson. And Bob is more suicide and more Bob than Arena. I agree. Bob is pretty Bob. But, Crimson, Greg has your love. Oh, man. That's rough. This is a rough day for me. Yeah. Unfortunately, did not get to ultimate that Lily. Sad, sad day. He's not Jason Lycanbrayer. Hits him for one a turn. Yep, yep, yep. Damn, this is a game. Probably Gatekeeper on kick just looks sad. It does look sad, but you know, it's something you gotta do. So what is on Bob's shirt? I believe it's just a myriad of Pokemon, I thought. Here, hold on, let's see if we can look in there. I thought it was a Pokemon shirt. Maybe it's not. Maybe that's, I'm gonna go weird Willy Wonka meets, Alice in Wonderland with the dude with the mustache. That's what I'm gonna go with. Been upvoting at, Marianne is Greg's, girlfriend. Yep. Rachel is my wife. So if you hear us talking about that, that would be where we're going. Vote miracles, Mark? Yeah, we'll try to get some miracles on camera. I don't believe there are any death and taxes tonight. Can you get someone playing mono white stacks on camera? I don't think we have mono white stacks. But if we did, I totally would because... I enjoy the stacks type of decks. Gibson offers Mark a waffle. Gibson, I'll take a waffle. Oh, Derp is the waffle. This is great. I like just being kind of behind and reading this stuff. It's all about Master of Waffles and Legacy. I agree. No, Master of Waves and Legacy. Maybe. I don't know. I'd have to see. I know Greg was playing Fish, and I know he's playing Master of Waves in either Modern or Legacy. I don't know, one of the two. Then yeah, that'll be good. And Dr. Derp is Rachel, apparently. I forgot about this. Just been trolling me this entire time. No, Johnny, even Murpho can't run them, although they do love Thassa. Thassa's nice. I like Thassa. Put it in. Little three drop. Manless Dredge versus Leylines. Why not? What's the most unique deck out there tonight? Probably that Mono Black deck, and that's why I put it on. Let's see. Chuck was nice enough to actually... bring everything down. So it looks like we got Esper. So Esper Blade, I believe. Then we have the Mono Black. The Enchantress, World Gorger. World Gorger we saw round one. There's Sneak and Show. Maverick, Reanimator, Miracles. Rug Delver. Lands, another Esper Blade, and a Miracles. So, yep. Two Miracles, two Esper Blades, one Rug Delver, one Lands, a Sneak and Show, World Gorger, an Enchantress, Mono Black, all that kind of fun stuff. I do look like a syrup salesman, and I am. I will sell you some syrup. It's that quality shit. It's delicious. You can get it if you want it. Wink. Come see me at a tournament. It'll be good. Oh, yeah, people were just asking for miracles, so this works.
Yeah. Right. I asked Pino and Kyle said, it's probably going to be quick, so there's no reason. He just didn't want to move.
Yeah. All right, so we'll get our pretty faces off of the camera, because, my God, we are beautiful men.
I agree.
Yeah. So we got Mr. Anthony Zinni.
Yep.
Like, this is weird. The heater's doing good things, uh-huh. But it's also, like, my feet are really cold.
Oh, my feet are frozen. It's because the ground is probably 2 degrees, and our feet are just resting on it, you know.
But now your feet are not.
Now I'm putting my feet in front of the heat.
Yeah, you're a smart man.
You could do the same if you really want.
Nope. I'm better than that.
We can put the heat by our feet.
So we got Bogner. Oh, Ryan Bogner is the deck that Ryan Bogner is playing. Miracles. All right, there we go.
Miracles is his name. Bogner is his game.
I like it. I like it. All right, so both these players, I believe, they actually... they are... Is this game 3?
Yes.
Because they both won their first game.
Yeah.
First rounds.
They are both good players.
I don't know.
Tony's made a spaghetti. He's still good at magic.
Tony has made a spaghetti. That is a fact.
Yes.
It's Tony Spaghetti-Zinni.
He doesn't have blood vessels. He just has spaghetti strands running through his body.
So what should we put on camera here? Or put on the card? Relevant card, Greg. Go.
Dig through time.
Dig. Oh, and Miracles?
It's in his hand. It's in both of their decks, I think.
All right, dig through time. Corner piece both these decks.
Actually, it might not be in Miracles at all.
It's in Zinni's hand. That's
yeah,
fine.
It's in Zinni's
hand. Looks like Bogner's taken a mulligan. Zinni's just got a shit ton of lands. Do you think he takes a mulligan too, right, or no?
I see a bunch. Looks like 2 or 3 at least.
I thought it was 4.
It might be 4. It might be 3 dual lands and a fetch.
Yeah.
And a dig...
No, he's got an island in there too because he's Zinni, so he's greedy as shit.
Yeah,
Zinni's probably got 18 basics in there.
Yeah,
in a 3-color deck.
Very often, my matches with him come down to either he gets mana screwed or not, because he always plays decks that are good against me except for their mana base.
Okay. No even Enchantress. Enchantress is on round 1. Unfortunately, did not do very well. If it won its game again, we'll try to get it on camera.
Looked like he was playing against lands. I'm not exactly sure how the Enchantress versus lands matchup goes.
No idea. What are the thoughts on Browbeat?
It's atrocious.
I have a good brow. And it beats.
You definitely like beating things.
Dragon Squared Entertainment, thank you for following. I'm impressed that I read that. Oh, no, it's Dragon Squad. But we'll go Dragon Squared because I like it better.
Yeah, it does sound better.
So Zinni just brainstorming.
Putting back some lands.
A little bit of main phase.
It's going to fetch them away, presumably.
No, keep them.
Keep them?
Keep them.
Okay.
You need 6 lands.
Okay.
So I like the fact that Zinni... kind of alluding to maybe he doesn't have just shit on in his hand and in the top of his deck by not immediately fetching, because now he can react to whatever Bogner does, like it's a little bit more important.
Sure.
All right, so
this is a force on a Stoneforge Mystic pitching a blue card that Snapcaster Mage. Sure.
Yeah. Infect Agent, thank you for following. I much appreciated. So yeah, Bogner cracked. That Scald and Tarn going down 19, and Zinni, of course, Force of Will. We'll bring Force of Will up.
I gather
most people watching probably know what it is, but
I wonder if Bogner is. I wonder if Bogner is playing the Stoneforge package in his main deck, or if it's sideboard. Because this is something that we've seen Brian Braun do with his Miracles lists. It's kind of unconventional. If you compare it to, like, the Europeans, how they like to play Miracles, or even Joe Lissette, he doesn't play Stoneforge Mystic typically. But I know BVD's tried Stoneforge, and
Bogner, I think, has tried a bunch of different configurations. He also likes Rest in Peace Helm in Miracles, but our other resident Miracles player, Nick Hess, prefers his Angels and Jaces. Just those.
Dragon Squared Entertainment feels very special that I said their name. Nice. Wilson, no, you can't be a mod. Infect Agent, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
Shut down so quickly. What if Kasali Pride Mage asked to be a mod?
No. Kasali Pride Mage has been banned on several occasions and will get a permaban if he does not
tone it down.
Him and Sasquatch X, they have very similar commenting styles.
What about Katy Perry Cherry Tree?
Is that Stefan too?
Yes.
Oh my god.
He has a lot of names. Yeah.
Because I saw that, and he was saying crazy shit there.
It's very easy to be a troll on Twitch.
It is.
Very easy.
But my banhammer relaxness is not what it once was.
Yeah.
Not what it once was.
You used to be more chill about...
Yes. Not anymore.
You used to be like the cool RA, now yep. You're like...
Nope, I'm like the
stick
fuck
up your
you.
Butt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm the fuck you RA right
That's
now.
That's cool.
Which could be good for them, yeah. You know? Because then you could say you're fucking an RA.
Yeah. Is that right?
Huh? No. I wish somebody donated $365 to us.
What?
That would be amazing. No, that's somebody donated $365 to Moobot.
Yeah,
because that would actually help me pay for this equipment.
To Moobot?
Yeah.
What
well,
is that?
Moobot's the service that we're using right here. Yeah, it's good things. We're not even paying attention to this game.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, good job. So
that's a thoughtseize. See,
so,
right back in it.
Let's see if... Bugner's going to force a will to this.
Brainstorm to hide something, probably.
Okay, that's fair. So, Swords to Plowshare and Red Elemental Bast off top, along with a Ponder. So we'll put two back. Probably the Dig Through Time, right? Dig Through Time, and what's the last card in his hand?
Dragon Squad is asking, how do I donate?
How do you donate? BJ Dennis, do not post fucking tubgirl.com and nobody click that link.
How do you ban people?
No, I don't need to ban people. I just need to like
give them a timeout.
Nope, I just want to like I can't. I don't know how to do that. how do you donate? There's a donate button if you scroll down below the stream. So
nice.
You're on the Twitch dashboard or like channel area.
Yeah.
Scroll a little below.
Yeah.
And there's a thing saying, hey, you can donate.
Hey.
Much appreciated if you do. Crimson, you did donate. You were the only person to have ever donated.
Boom.
Yep. So, I appreciate. Sorry, so we're still waiting for this Thoughtseize to resolve. Zinni's going to go down
Indeed.
To 16 from casting it, though.
I think he's taking
it resolved.
Taking Swords of Plowshares.
So what is he... Is that a... What is that?
That's
is that
a
Council
judgment?
Okay. Council's Judgment!
Indeed.
It's gonna do some judgment! As part of a council!
It's a great card.
Oh, it's a stupid card. I hate it. They're like, you know what? Let's print a fucking True Name Nemesis. This is busted. Oh, shit. We need an answer to True Name Nemesis. Let's print Judge's Council's Judgment because that fixes things. No, it's like...
The same mana cost.
Yeah. Let's just print a more busted card and make it,
it's definitely less busted.
Let's give it to a color that already has various answers for True Name Nemesis, too. Like...
You mean like Day of Judgment?
Yeah.
Sure.
Day of Judgment, Supreme Verdict.
This is a...
Things like that.
I wonder what this is naming. Presumably Red Elemental Blast, actually.
Yeah, I'm not...
I think?
Well, it has to be, or else
unless
it's
it just wants
be...
to be bait
yeah.
for the Red Blast.
Quite possibly.
Looks like this is just getting countered by Red Blast, though. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so Bogner realizing that it was just going to be essentially a discard spell for his Red Blast... Just opts to counter it with that card.
Yeah. Greg, you keep talking about this. I'm gonna read through.
Okie dokie.
Read through this stuff.
Here's a dig from Bogner. Probably looking for a Sensei's Divining Top and a counterbalance. There's a Terminus. Two Terminus. Flusterstorm. Flooded Strand. Brainstorm. Not the most impressive dig ever. Doesn't look like there are any of his engine pieces here. Looks like he took a land and an unknown card.
Did we miss another fetch?
I don't believe so.
Okay. And no, I was not an RA. Greg just insinuated that I was, so I went with it.
So he took fetch land plus Sensei's Divining Top.
Does Detention Sphere work on True Name? No.
No,
no
sir.
Unfortunately, it does not.
Wrath of God and Supreme Verdict do.
Yes, they do.
As does Council's Judgment. And Engineer Explosives on 3.
Yep. I do that in Modern a lot.
Here is a Force of Will on a Stoneforge Mystic. Tony looking at a Dig Through Time in his hand.
So he probably doesn't care too much, right?
He also has Counterspell.
Ooh. All right. So how much do you care about the Stoneforge then?
Huh. So he's digging response.
That seems riskier than just going Counterspell, right?
Yes.
Maybe he just doesn't care enough because, like, Dig might hit him something else that's good.
It's possible. Yeah, Jace. That's pretty good.
Jace and Click. So maybe he just takes Jace and Click and then lets the Force of Will resolve.
Yeah. Well, looks like he might want his Stoneforge. Nope.
Oh, Snapcaster.
Snapcaster Dig is a thing? Not for many turns, but at some point.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I would want to take the Jace.
Yeah, I do too. I feel like just Jace Click, right?
Looks like he wants this Stoneforge to resolve.
Yeah, okay, so Force of Will and Snapcaster.
We're not.
Nope.
So he wants to save a Force of Will for when Bogner finds Counterbalance. Anticipating the game going real long, and he wants a leg up if that happens.
That's fair. All right. Yeah. There's Dig Through Time and Counterbalance on top of Ryan's deck. Oof. Rough. So what do you pitch to force here? Do you pitch the Counterspell or do you pitch the...
Snap? I think you pitch the Counterspell because then you still have access to Snap Counterspell, right?
No, because you're exiling the Counterspell.
Oh, you're right. Sorry. And yeah, I'd probably pitch the Snapcaster.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking, too.
I guess he has Snap Thoughtseize, but Bogner only has one card in hand, so, like, the chances that it matters are not the best. Tony definitely has a decision now.
Yeah. Mark, what's my favorite god? Or what is your favorite? My favorite god?
Okay.
Karanos.
If he draws a land, he can... Oh, he drew Counterspell? No, drew Brainstorm.
So he did Force, right?
Okay. He did. So he said 15.
I'll give you a 15. My feet are going to freeze off.
Oh, they are. Mine, I think, have...
Maybe we just move this down.
Maybe.
Let's put this on.
You can also move your jacket away.
So you can move your jacket away. How about that, Greg?
Mine's on my body. Brainstorm from Tony.
All right.
I don't know why he tapped...
Oh, basic my God, mount. That feels amazing. That was the best idea. That was the best idea.
It was a great idea.
Freudian slip.
I wonder what they're talking about here.
I don't quite know either. Maybe in response to the brainstorm? Whoa.
Earthquake.
I think that somehow made the camera angle better.
It's all right. So Tony looking at some stinkers in his top few. He has two lands there.
Yeah.
No fetch.
Was it?
So he has Force plus Snap. This is Snap Thoughtseize.
Oh, Thoughtseize. Okay, sure. Council Judgment. All right.
That's fine. I think Bogner's advantage from this position.
Yeah, because...
Tony's basically on empty. Like, he's going to be able to play a land next turn, but...
Oh, and Zinni's at 13. Yeah. And we also know that Bogner's got the Dig Through Time now.
Oh, right. Probably the best follow-up possible.
Yeah. No, not a bad one. Oh, yeah, go ahead and Thoughtseize me. Let me get this Dig Through Time off the top.
Yeah. We know... What's the card in Tony's hand?
Force of Will, right?
Okay, so next turn he'll have a fifth land. Ooh, so getting to force the dig is going to be pretty good.
Yeah. So apparently he had... So Bogner.
He still has to delve.
Oh, but I guess
still chat, has to delve.
Yeah, chat saying that Bogner revealed the top card, thinking he had Counterbalance in play. I don't think that's anything that we need to run upstairs for, though.
Did
That's what they were saying.
Oh.
I don't know.
They might have been talking to Chuck about that. Here's the land.
Dragon, how long have we been doing the Twitch stream? I don't know. September.
I think we missed an attack or two, maybe. Snap just got in again.
No, I don't think we missed an attack. This will be the first time, right?
No. I think it's hit him twice.
You sure?
Yes.
All right. I believe you, Greg.
Ooh, that's a Keranos. Oh, that's really good.
Yeah.
What is that card? What did he just... Oh, True Name. Wow, that's really good. Jeez, these are some haymakers.
Yep. All right, so we'll bring up Keranos. My favorite god.
Good grief. I have two of this in my modern sideboard.
Do you... Oh, for...
In Twin.
Twin?
It's yeah. So fun. So he can top as well. Oh, my God. This is insane. You can top plus Keranos. You set up what is going to be revealed.
All right,
that
so you just draw a card.
That is disgusting.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Well, and you can put the trigger on the stack if you reveal a land, so that, and then you top in response.
So you don't even have to draw.
So you don't even have to draw the land.
Reveal the first card you draw on each of your turns. So you are drawing the card.
Oh, okay, sure.
It's not like...
Oh, so you draw an additional card.
Yeah, it's not like at the beginning of your draw step, reveal the top card. It's not like that.
I know these things.
It looks like Bogner just got to draw an extra card that turn. He does need to find Terminus sooner rather than later. Also, he got hit for 5 that turn. Sorry. So he should be at 8, I think.
Greg, I'm looking at chat.
I know, I'm sorry.
Oh, wait, he's 8.
Yes.
All right. I still don't think he got hit twice.
He needs Terminus.
I think he's at 10.
Okay.
That's just me.
Well, it's a 2-turn clock.
And it looks like Keranos just drew him an extra card again?
Yeah, I think...
To the max! Thank you for following.
He's taking a line where he really just needs to find Terminus, and then the game will end.
Sure.
Or at least presumably will end.
And there's a Swords to Plowshare?
Yeah, that's not great, though. The problem is the True Name.
Yep, and Ryan going ahead and fetching it away, putting him down to 7. That doesn't really speed the clock up at all.
Ryan can kill the Snapcaster basically whenever just by setting it up with the Keranos trigger. And, like, he might do that for... now I guess he's kind of locked into finding Terminus, actually.
Yeah. Takes another 5, puts him down to 2.
Yeah, looks like he's going to top now. Looking for it. Doesn't look
it's
like he found
nothing.
It.
Nothing, wow. It's been a lot of top activations.
It really has.
Like, a lot of top activations and shuffle effects. Right. Yeah, don't whiff.
I mean, yeah. he has one more shot at it. Next turn, presumably. This is also assuming that Tony doesn't have a Snapcaster end of turn or something.
Yeah. Do we know what's in Tony's hand?
A land and an unknown card.
Okay. Oh, moving that heater down was, like, the best decision ever.
It was definitely a good idea. This heater is definitely less effective than my own.
No.
I mean, also don't want to... definitely better than nothing.
Yeah, we also don't want to blow a fuse, so...
you know.
This happened before. It's terrible.
Really?
Chandra! Yeah.
Oh.
I was not happy. Because the... table toppers next, like, that were in the other basement on the other side.
Yeah.
Had, like, 4 fucking
heaters running
from, like, a single extension cord.
Smart.
That they were pulling from this side. And it wasn't even that cold, and it blew the fuse on this side, not that side.
That's terrific.
I was upset.
Doesn't look like he has one there. Still searching for Terminus.
All right, so was that the Swords of Plowshare that took out? I believe so.
So,
because I see it in the yard.
Bogner able to dig 2 cards down into his deck this turn. Yeah.
So there's a Jace. Jace not going to do anything. Another top. Oof.
He has a fetch, but he can't really afford to fetch now because True Name is just going to kill him. Brainstorm.
Yep. Flusterstorm. Yeah,
that was
we
the
know
last
it's...
one. Well, he puts 2 back now, and now he can top and look at 3. Like, it gets him 1 deeper into the deck.
Yeah, okay.
He could also crack fetch if he wants to be very aggressive, but he's probably just going to do that
Well,
and I believe we're in turns.
There's very close tree. That's too late, though.
Oh, all right. Zinni got it.
Maybe he was at three.
Yeah. All right. Maybe, yeah, we might have missed a fetch.
Yeah.
Or he actually was at four, and Bogner's just conceding because he knows that he can't actually win.
He could have, though. Like,
Entreat for a lot? I don't know.
From that spot, I mean, he goes to one, like...
Oh, what do we want to put on camera?
Next round?
Yeah, I think people were saying Enchantress.
I mean, whatever's...
People were saying Enchantress. Well,
what's 2-0?
I don't know. I'll go up. You want to go up and make the call?
No, you go.
All right. I'll be right back, guys.
If Nathan's doing well, he's playing Rug Delver. I'm a fan of Rug Delver. I know no one else is. So, in our booth, what do we got going on in the chat here? Keranos looked pretty good that game, but it was just, couldn't stand up to True Name. True Name is, kind of sad that that card exists. It is just a pretty stupid card. When it was first spoiled, I was still playing Merfolk at that time, and, I thought, whoa, Merfolk might be really good now, because I get to play four of this amazing card, and no one was talking about it then. And then people put in Stoneblade, and it's obnoxiously good. So, it's unfortunate. Dragon Squad asks, where are you guys recording? We are recording from the basement of Dice Dojo, which is a card shop on the north side of Chicago. And we come from here every Monday night.
And every Wednesday night?
Not from here, though.
Not from here?
Yes. Someone asked where we were.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Monday's here. Wednesday and Thursday are at another store.
MGG Card Market, yep.
Another shop.
Wednesdays is Modern.
Yeah.
Thursdays is Legacy again.
People were also asking earlier if there's a giveaway tonight.
No giveaway tonight.
Okay, just no. Wednesday, Thursday.
Yeah, I'm far behind. I have t-shirts to give away.
Okay.
But I'm just so far behind shipping stuff out, I don't want to get...
I forgot to wear my t-shirt today.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. I can't wear anything other than plaid.
Okay.
It's in my contract.
Okay. You should get plaid Wooberg shirts.
What if we just had Wooberg printed out
and
like
plaid.
In plaid?
In yeah. plaid.
Well, no, I'm just like that actually makes the stripes for plaid. It's just Wooberg written. Oh no!
Did they hit it?
It kind of looked like they hit it.
It's not too bad.
But it's not the worst.
Bogner, don't hit it.
I might have to run up. Maybe not. Greg, and you're sitting here the whole time. You have moved seats.
Luxac Delver Flip. Chicago is cold AF at the moment. I believe it is 1 degree outside.
Yeah, it's not a pleasant thing.
It's not great living here in the winter. The summer, it's amazing.
How did...
What?
Did Simon get a pair down?
I don't know. Why?
Because that's...
Bob?
That's Bob. All right, so we're seeing the two most interesting decks in the room.
Enchantress and Mono Black.
Yeah, so Enchantress. So Simon did win. Apparently,
okay.
One of the games came down.
He was playing against lands, right? Simon was?
No, because he talked about his opponent Force of Willing something.
Well, Bowman is playing blue lands.
Oh, is he?
I don't know if there's Force of Will in the deck, but...
Bob lost, right?
Bob is 0-2.
Okay, Bob is 0-2. And Rug Delver was 0-2.
Oh, okay.
So.
Come on, Nathan. What are you doing?
I don't know.
Get your head out of your butt.
Next round we'll do whoever's got the highest record.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's not drawing.
But no, I mean, we'll still put him on camera. We'll say, hey.
Hey, you play.
You play. You play now.
You play.
This will be good.
Evan asks what the meta is like in Chicago. I think at our store, there's a lot of fair decks most of the time. And I would clarify it. There's a good amount of fair decks. There's not a lot of Delver specifically. There's not that many people who play like Rug Delver or Bug Delver. Yes.
Kramer Row?
You got it.
That's how I say Kramer.
Mm-hmm.
FYI. All right. We'll go ahead and start the timer.
Oh, CPT is trying to have a dick measuring contest with us.
Oh.
1 degree, amateurs. It's negative 30, factoring in the wind in Quebec.
Oh, fuck you. All right, you want to talk about wind chill?
Okay, it's well, the same shit here. Yeah. We have the fucking lake.
Quebec. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
There's a thought, see.
It's 1 degree without the wind chill, and it's also Fahrenheit, not Celsius.
Yeah, you're like, blah, 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 blah.
I actually don't know if Canada uses Fahrenheit or Celsius.
No, I'm pretty sure they use Celsius.
All right, so then I don't know what that guy's talking about. 1 degree Celsius, it's not that cold.
No, I know. 1 degree Celsius, not bad at all. We'll bring up Thopsies. Why not? Makes it relevant. Thopsies from Bob. And looks like, is that Utopia Sprawl, right?
Mm-hmm.
Utopia. Right? Utopia Sprawl. Bam. There we go.
Yeah.
Oh, and Bob just plays a Bajuka Bog. oh, God, there's a Sterling Grove.
Jeez.
All right. Sterling Grove.
I'm pretty sure this matchup's really bad for Mono Black.
Yep. Yep. All right, so we're probably going to get another thing.
That's another Bajuka Bog.
Oh, man. And so
he's, why was it just revealed?
Because he sacked it. He played Sterling Grove, sacked it to get...
I see.
Was there Enchantress's Presence?
Gotcha. Sorry.
So,
yeah.
Put that in. Now getting in play. Playing another... What the fuck is that card?
What?
Oh, is that a... That's a Dash Ups!
Oh my god. He is playing Dash Ups.
What? Yes! Yes!
What just happened?
Did he just put it back in his
is
hand?
Is it not countered? Could it not be countered? What is the point here?
I don't
know.
Did he not have mana? And Bob was just saying, hey, I wish I could cast this.
Oh, it was tapped? I missed what happened there.
I have no clue. Chad, if you saw what happened.
Yeah, did anyone notice what happened there?
Let us know.
Why didn't he dash hopes?
I don't.
Does Sterling Grove say anything about, like, can't be countered?
No?
It just says can't be targeted, right?
Yeah, they just have Shroud. Unless that was a different card, it looked like Dash Hopes, right?
Yeah, it kind of did.
I really hope Bob made this when I was joking about playing Dash Hopes. And he was like, you know what? I'm going to make a deck where you can play Dash Hopes in. But there's a Sigil of the Empty Throne.
Johnny Turbo says, if it turns out Bob has... Sengir, or no, Irini. Who's Irini Sengir? Is that a relation to Sengir Vampire? Is that a card? Irini Sengir?
You should be...
I don't know what that card does. Whoa.
White enchantments and green enchantments each cost an additional 2 to cast.
What the fuck?
Why not? 4 drop? Got it.
It's sad that I don't actually think that's good against Enchantress. But...
Oh, man. But here's an Elephant Grass. This is, like, they're playing really fast. This is hard. And Greg's watching chat instead of this.
Well, someone called out Irini Sengir. I thought that was pretty sweet.
Elephant Grass, black creatures cannot attack you. Just period.
Yeah, well.
Just period.
Yeah, this seems like a tough matchup for Bob. Also, Simon's win condition's already in play. So basically, any enchantments that Simon draws are just going to let him...
Yeah. So he's going
to... Get out of control, basically. He'd have to draw many... Nope, that's a Miri's call. Now it's basically impossible for him to draw a running string of lands between the Arid Mesa and the Miri's Guile.
Yeah. And he's going to go ahead and fetch. He's going to go down to... I believe that's his first fetch, right?
Yes.
Looks like it. So he's going to get down to 19. I imagine he's going to be paying that cumulative upkeep as long as he possibly can.
Probably.
He's got to worry...
As long as he needs to.
Yeah.
He is playing it. Wow, he caved. He hated this card for so long.
All right, so excuse us. We said Eidolon of Blossoms not being played.
Maybe he's playing like one. Crazy.
But he is playing it. All right, fair enough.
Yeah.
Discard
City of Solitude. Great art. Great art.
This is. I'm just typing as fast as I can. Greg, you gotta commentate here.
Well, the game's
gonna
swing. That
Blood Moon's gonna do a lot.
This game's gonna swing pretty quickly because Lily's not gonna get to ultimate here.
No. Yeah, those are 2-4-4 angels swinging in there.
Indeed.
And now.
What was
I don't. That must not have been Dash Hope.
He could have blocked with the Nighthawk just to save the Lily, but I guess that doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
Is Bob basically conceding here?
Yeah, I think so. That's a Sarah Sanctum. I'm going to go find out what that card is that Bob played, though.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
Oof. Chantress's Presence. He also made about a billion mana off of the Sarah Sanctum there. And it has 4/4/4 Flying Angels. And is drawing 4 cards off of every enchantment currently. Mark Hand being seen there. Ah, is it Crippling Affliction? Malicious Infliction.
It was Malicious Affliction, yeah. And so that's what he was trying to do because he thought it was Argothian Enchantress, not Enchantress's Presence.
Womp womp.
Yep. Suiting up, Greg?
Yes.
How is Semin on 1 yet?
Well...
Okay.
Dr. Derp asked the same question, and the answer is he just won.
Okay. Fair enough.
Do you know which Pokemon that is that he's using?
Apium? Apium?
Apium? Apium? Does that show up in Gather?
I don't think it does.
I don't think so either.
Don't believe it does. Yeah, so we'll probably end up getting another match, right?
Yeah, Dr. Derp, it is the one with the hand tail, I think.
Retrocreek Plastic, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
Thank you.
Yes. Alright, let's see. Okay.
Anything going on in chat?
I don't know. 42 in Atlanta, very cold.
Oh, yeah, that sounds awful.
Yeah, that's t-shirt weather. I remember when I used to... When I used to think that was cold.
I don't think I can remember what it's like to be warm, actually.
That's fair. It's been a long winter.
Like, outside and warm.
Yeah.
The last two have been very long.
Yeah. Very, very much so. This one started out not bad, and then it was like, fuck you!
Yeah, it took a turn in, like, early December.
Duckle-a-mop! Thank you for following. Much appreciated.
The thing that's a killer is just that February doesn't relent. And really, March doesn't that much either.
And Derp, I said, thank you for tuning in, because I know you followed in the past.
Oh, right.
You can't pull the wool over my eyes so much, unless you're a recent follow, and then I haven't learned your name in chat yet.
Right.
And then again, we've got like 1,200 followers now, and a lot of people that tune in regularly.
Damn.
And so it's hard for me to remember.
Oh, everybody. Gabby was, she was talking to me. She wants to try to do some sort of, like, crossover thing.
Some crossover thing with her
like
stream?
Like, with the stream, yeah.
Sure.
We don't really know. We couldn't decide.
I have no idea
something.
How that would work.
I know. She wasn't sure either what the best thing would be for both parties. Maybe something on Magic Online, because that's most...
Probably.
That's where she streams from.
I might have, like, a stream party at my house.
Sure.
I don't know. Jeffrey K, thank you for being here. Much appreciated.
If we can give her a legacy deck to play on Modo and then see her
I got some legacy decks.
Yeah.
I have a lot of cards on Modo.
It might be very entertaining to try to see Gabby try to play Mud online.
Give her blue Mud too, so it's like even more obscure. Oh man. I like this idea. Alright, anyway, Legacy has really high viewer counts in Magic the Gathering section compared to other formats pretty consistently. Awesome to see, yeah.
Well, we're one of the more regular Legacy streams, I guess.
We're
at
pretty...
At least for live content.
Yeah, that and we actually commentate as well.
That's
which
right.
Which we're pretty much the only people other than Wizards and Star City that provide...
Yeah, most
commentary
of the,
on live Magic.
Most of the in-store ones are just a camera.
Jeez. Simon starting out with 2 ley lines in play.
He might have wanted to keep one in his hand just to be able to cast later to get a trigger, a draw trigger.
Yeah.
Or not.
I mean, I don't know. I think you can just say, like, don't worry about it. But he is going to fetch. He's going to bring it down to 19. I feel like Sugagugas, sup guy. Oh, sup guys. I feel like I feel, really? I don't know. Thank you for following. Much appreciated. I feel like they followed before.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Could be wrong. So I'm going to fetch again. I'm going to get on to 18 after just a pass of the turn back by Bob. Do we know what's in Bob's hand? I saw a swamp. But unfortunately, I was changing life totals, so the little box is over. And there is an Argothi Enchantress. So if Bob has... Bob does have swamp. If he's got Gatekeeper, this could be a pretty... No, because its target player sacrifices a creature.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yeah, never mind.
Gatekeeper doesn't do anything.
Bad.
Toxic Deluge for one.
All right, so Bob's going to lose one life. We'll bring up Toxic Deluge. Why not?
One of the few ways for him to interact with Simon at all, really.
Yeah.
But Simon still has his engine cooking here.
Yeah, I mean, he's still got a Miri's Guile, right?
Yep.
Yeah. No, this is going to be rough.
Got Miri's Guile, got another Enchantress effect, and here's a Phyrexian Arena from Bob.
And there's an Eidolon of Blossoms. I can't believe he's playing Eidolon of Blossoms.
Yeah.
After all of the crap he talked.
He really did talk a lot of crap about it.
I'm a little upset, even.
It is somewhat upsetting.
Yeah.
I agree.
Okay, so there's an Enchantress's presence.
Yep.
So he elects not to play the...
The one that can Eidolon. Be killed.
Yeah. Which is fine.
Yeah.
Again, it's going to be hard for him to kill because he's got two fucking...
Bob losing a life there from the arena.
Very good call. You're a gentleman and a scholar,
not
Mr. Schaefer.
Not that either player's life total is going to be too relevant here, I think.
Yeah, and I think Simon's got another land, yeah. So he's very ready to throw that away.
Yeah, Liliana's not going to be terribly effective.
And he's about to recall here.
Why didn't... he could have gone down with the Lily.
No, he couldn't.
Why not? Oh, Leyline. Target.
Yeah, he's just...
Oh, God. Yeah. That's so bad.
Yeah.
Target
player sacrifices a creature. Yeah,
that's really blows.
Not gonna do good things.
That's terrible.
Simon is going to fetch. He's going to go down to 17. And like I said, because it was two lands and a ley line on top, doesn't want any of that. And he's about to Ancestral this turn as soon as he plays this Idolism. Yep.
Yeah.
There we go.
He's hit a Sarah Sanctum?
Did he?
Nope.
Oh.
Forest.
He still hit two lands again. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's rough.
I mean, it's all right for him.
Yeah, Shoddy Too Hotty. As I said before earlier on the stream, I've just been backlogged like crazy. So things are coming. I'm addressing things tomorrow because I bought a bunch of envelopes and everything like that. And then cards and T-shirts are going to be shipping out relatively soon. So should be on Wednesday that they'll be shipping out. Everything will come. And once I actually do ship them, they get there pretty fast, as long as you're in the States.
Simon just drew 9 cards this turn, I believe.
Simon just drew 9 cards. Sometimes you draw 9 cards, you know?
Yeah, he played the Eidolon, then he drew 3. And then he played Miri's Guile, drew 3.
Oh, and then
Elfengrass, draw 3.
Why not? Bob's at 17.
Right. He's ticking up to old. That's all he can do. Oh, no.
Oh, no, he tried. He tried. That's not going
to
work.
So he's at 4. Can go up to 5.
He's looking at the Gatekeeper Malakir. We'll bring up Gatekeeper. Gatekeeper not going to do anything either.
The ultimate does stuff. Like, it definitely does stuff.
Oh, certainly. But I think, honestly, though, it'd be incredibly hard to pick the piles in this situation.
I put basically...
All the Enchantress effects in one pile, all of his lands in another?
I might. Also, you can do some funny stuff with the enchanted forests.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I don't think you give him any lands with any of the...
Right.
So all of his lands have to be in one.
The problem, though, with splitting it all lands, all enchantments, is he has 7 cards in his hand. He probably has more lands, you know? Yeah. And if the next land is Sarah Sanctum, then that could turn out pretty poorly.
Yeah.
Here we get another draw 3.
Yep. Oh, God.
Yeah.
This is pretty gross.
He's really just missing the Sanctum, or he'd go fully nuts. Like, he still has his mana holding him back a little bit.
Yeah, I think Bob had to just basically have mono discard for the first, like, 8 turns of the game.
Right.
And
just keep all Enchantress effects out of play. I think he might have just hit the Sanctum. Maybe not, actually.
Grave Merchant doesn't target though, right?
Kyle or Simon moving to discard here.
Yeah.
Discard a couple bunch fetches. Of stuff. Excess lands. I don't think he's anticipating the Liliana actually getting to ultimate here because he has 2/4/4 flyers in play.
Yeah.
Here's a Bajuka Bog, it looks like. Targeting his own. Nope. It's all graveyards.
Yeah,
right?
It's all graveyards, I believe. Oh, maybe not.
Maybe not.
Oh, no, it's got to be...
It's target graveyard, right? So he has to target his own.
We'll bring it up.
That's gross. I think Simon also has Replenish in his hand.
Exile all cards on target player's graveyard.
Woof.
Ugh. Yeah. Ugh. Then Bob has to target himself. Oh, that's rough.
He also cannot Cabal Therapy.
Yeah. Rough and stuff. Well, he could have. He could have flashed it back from...
He could have Cabal Therapied himself.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
These ley lines have been good.
Oh, man. Lily's... Oh, does Lily on his ult target?
It might.
Does it actually target? It does.
Oh, God. It doesn't do anything. Maybe he targeted himself.
Yeah, so if I was Simon, I would have just ignored it.
Yeah.
Like, you're drawing three cards, at least three cards a turn.
I mean, this is really just like, what is the fewest number of things I have to do to make Bob concede? Yeah.
Simon's just sitting over there like, hey, do you like this?
Yeah.
You like this? It goes up and down.
Yep.
Up and down.
Up and down.
Up and down.
Up and down.
Legacy are bads, moderns is kings. Maybe.
I don't hate Modern. Yeah. A lot of people really dislike it. I think I finally found a deck that I enjoy playing. That's nice.
All right, let's see.
Eternal formats are all just about finding something you enjoy, and you're going to enjoy for a long time.
Yes.
There's Gary. Does Gary target? No, it's all opponents, right? Gary doesn't target.
Yes, right? Gary does not target. So how much is this?
That's a drain for six.
Yeah, there's a lot of... Okay, sure, there's a drain for six.
But I think Bob is dead on the crackback.
Yeah.
He has four angels in play.
Yeah, he's got more than four.
Oh, wait, he's gaining six.
Yeah, so Bob's at 24, but did Bob take any hits from these angels before?
I don't think so, because Liliana was killed the last turn.
All right, so let's see.
This is an attack for 20, it looks like. I think Bob's at four.
Okay.
Here's Words of War.
This should deal the last few points.
Is there Sarah Sanctum somewhere? And, yep, more Garys.
Yeah.
Interesting that Bob wasn't playing. Maybe he just drew them.
Oh, yeah, the Garys?
It seems like one of the few ways he could actually win there.
Yeah, just slam it down.
Yeah, basically. I mean, Simon wasn't gaining life.
Well, do you want to go see if we can get another match?
Sure.
You can get out of the cold.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So we'll bring it back to the booth, guys. You get to see me. All right. Legacy's king. I agree. Very good. Let's see. Adamant. Don't tell SCJ. Everybody start trading in their fetches for duels and nearly bankrupt them again. Maybe. I don't know. Hey, can I give you guys a shout-out on social media? Yeah! Yes, you can give us a shout-out on social media. That would be most appreciated, Dragon. Most appreciated. Yeah, and I know there are definitely some other stores that do streaming and stuff, but a lot of them don't necessarily have commentators. I've seen a couple where people are, like, they're talking through their plays, a la, like, the Versus series from Star City Games. But there's also a lot of background noise, and at least we've tried to mitigate that somewhat with ours. Yeah, I've already addressed the shipping the shirt out, all that kind of fun stuff. Toxic Deluge versus Drowning Sorrow, which should I use? If it's in Legacy, then Toxic Deluge is my personal opinion there. Just because you can kill Batterskulls with it, which is relevant. Honestly think that the U.S. Center Drive inside because fuck the Queen? Yeah, possibly. Restgrn! Thank you for following. Much appreciated.
We're
going to
have
Ryan Bogner
and Kyle Norman.
All right, so Ryan Bogner, Kyle Norman. Yeah, Dragon Squad, I'm sorry. I apologize. Greg was looking at the chat the entire time and said nothing.
You're welcome.
You're a bad person, Greg.
I think these guys are 1-1, unless there was a pair down, because we saw Bogner lose last round to Tony, right?
Yes. Yeah.
And these guys are going to game 3. So I presume Kyle lost a round.
Oh, and it looks like somebody knocked the camera. Well, it's very close because I can see the tape up there.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
All right, so let me reset this. Guys, I still haven't caught up with chat really quick. Greg, I'm going to pass this to you. I'll let you do this while I'm kind of going through. Actually, you can't do
There's
that.
There's no way to do that.
So is this game three for them?
Yes. Mark, just going to reset the overlay real quick.
And then I'll jump back.
Kyle Norman on the right, playing, or Miracles on the left there.
Miracles.
Ryan Bogner.
We're seeing a lot of same faces on tonight.
Yeah, well, it's just how the timing lined up here.
Yeah, well, which is fair. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
Right.
I
was just trying to keep the downtime lower.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, it's fine. Kyle Norman. Crimson Viper is asking for blue eye red tokens on camera. I don't know. What does that involve?
I don't think we have that.
Does that mean Jeskai Ascendancy, or does that just mean like Monastery Mentor plus Young Pyromancer?
Oh, it might be the Jeskai Ascendancy, the deck that Chuck plays.
Yeah.
Quite possibly.
We haven't seen a Mentor deck in Legacy.
All right. You keep an eye on this. I'm going to go through this. I'm going to bring up World Gorger Dragon just because. Okay, cool. Crazy to see World Wars and Legacy deck. Yes. What other decks are playing tonight?
Got a list right there.
Yeah, we got Esper Blade, we got Enchantress, Sneak and Show, Maverick, Reanimator, Miracles, World Gorger Dragon, Rug Delver, Lands, Esper.
We're good here.
All that kind of fun stuff.
Ryan leading with a Flood Strand, and we have a Ponder out of Kyle.
Yep. I watched the Happy because they don't. Because I don't sleep, and they have like hour long downtimes between matches. All right, fair enough. Technically, if you put a bleeder on a frequency. What? I don't even know. Dragon says we're the best. Awesome. I miss when wizards let you hear the table talk during matches. Yeah, you could probably do that. I mean, like, we tried that, but there's just so much background noise with all the other people that are in there.
It would be easier to do it on a different day, but when it's today and they have all the freaking Pathfinder people yelling everywhere, so it's pretty hard. This is a duress on Kyle's second turn here. Bogner is just led with two uncracked fetch lands thus far. Yeah. Looking at a hand with Force of Will, Top, Swords to Plowshares, Jace, and two more lands.
Yeah.
It's probably going to take the Force of Will, leave Bogner with... Oh, that's an entreat, not a top. Sorry.
Well, here's fucking Gatherer, and they're like weird... There we go.
He has to take Force of Will. I don't know what he's... I mean, you can take Plow, I guess, but Force is just more Kyle fanning,
putting it back together, not actually moving cards.
Yeah.
I
think he just... he's taking Jace.
And that is a foil Fishy Ponder, correct? And Funky, no problem. Shameless plugs are okay. Should Shameless plug us, if you would like. I've actually watched that stream before, the Dublin stream, and I chatted about English politics with them.
Dublin stream?
Yeah.
What are they?
Ireland.
Yeah, I understand, but what are they?
Ireland. Dublin's in Ireland.
Yeah, they stream Dublin.
The Erie.
Do they stream Legacy?
No, I think it's Modern. Okay. Or I think I forgot what I was watching when I was watching in stream.
Is it
I was
in
just
a
having
store
fun.
Or is it?
Yeah, it's a store.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, 19 for Bogner.
I guess he drew Counterbalance. That's a good one.
Womp, 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 womp.
It's a pretty good one.
Yeah, not bad.
Not gonna lie.
Not bad.
See, it is a slightly exposed here. Oh, this is a force from Kyle.
Yeah, no, Funky, I know you fall. I remember when you followed. I try to remember these things.
So his only protection here is the Swords to Plowshares, because he doesn't have a blue card for force. Kyle taking Jace with the duress is very interesting. It seems like it's signaling that Kyle wants to play for a longer game. But
against Miracles, do you want to do that?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, countering the counterbalance is a good way to make that happen, I suppose. Or at least you go to a longer game and you still have a shot, you know? Here we see a fetch from Kyle.
Molar, thank you for following. I think I scared Greg with that.
You did.
That was good. Yeah. It's good.
Yep.
I want whatever job Kyle does to pay for these upper middle class foils.
Oh.
He's most of his cards are foil.
Yeah, he works with Epic.
Yep, electronic medical records.
So he gets that hospital money. That hospital money.
That hospital money.
Yeah.
All right, so ponder from Kyle and...
You can get the hospital money without having to go to medical school. That seems like the way to do it.
Mammoth Gaming 93, appreciate following as well. So he's just, what, digging for an Entomb?
It's hard to say.
Oh, and I missed a Forcible from Kyle, so Kyle is actually at 18.
Right.
Because Greg can't keep up with this shit. Yep. Tell me.
This has been
I'm going to tie you in a little knot.
Definitely been a long turn for Kyle.
Here. Yep.
I'm all tied up.
Yep. Greg has got a choker on? I don't know what's going on right now.
No. Just a hat.
Just a hat.
Kyle's passing the turn back here. He's fetching.
Nope.
Okay.
This is Kyle. Kyle's like, this is my turn.
Yeah.
I take my turns.
Definitely seems.
Underground Sea coming in. Fair enough.
Bogner doing us the courtesy of playing with his hand exposed here. If he draws a blue card, he's pretty well protected from Kyle's combo.
Yeah. Does Kyle has another force, right?
He has Thoughtseize. He can Thoughtseize the Swords to Plowshares. He can also Swords. Thoughtseize the Force of Will if he wants.
Okay.
Presumably he already knows what he's taking if he's casting this. Yeah. Takes Swords.
Sure.
Forces Bogner to draw a blue card to make the Force of Will relevant.
Yeah. Goes down to 15 in the process.
And we won't know if it is a blue card or not. Plays the fetch land, passes the turn. If it's another land, next turn he can just hard cast Force. The Entreat's pretty dead in his hand, though.
Yeah, and so Kyle's got...
Brainstorm, okay.
Kyle has two anime deads in hand.
Sure. So he's just digging for Entomb?
Yeah. I think he's just looking for any way to get a World Quarter Dragon in the yard.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he has one in his hand, so he can't just, like, Thoughtseize himself.
No. Oh, but he does have a Dig Through Time. He found a Dig Through Time off of that, which is huge.
Sure. That's good.
Yeah. Because odds are he's going to hit an Entomb.
Right.
I don't remember if he had another land in hand, though.
Mm-hmm.
So, which is important. Crimson, I saw that you donated. I was going to say thank you very much when we got to a little... Because it just vibrated in my pocket, and I pulled it out, and I saw that, and I much appreciated.
Yippee!
The Conductor, thank you for following. However, it's like
this
straight edge of the Conductor.
Through time. Delving 6.
All right, so odds are he's got a hit. Something here,
you'd
right?
I think so.
Yeah. Being very careful what he's delving away. Leaving.
He plays Snapcaster, yeah. So it's kind of relevant. I mean, you basically just leave yourself a discard spell and a cantrip.
Yeah. Which is what he was doing.
Yeah.
So looks like Bogner fetched in response. He's going to go down to 18.
Sure.
Ooh, Counterflux. That's a card.
That is awesome. Dig Through Time is not resolving.
No, that's actually really big.
Yeah. Now if he draws land, Forcible is on.
And Forcible is going to be very big.
Yep, there's land.
Yeah.
So 5 mana Forcible, now active.
Johnny Turbo, Ryan Bogner is a pretty well-known pro player. I mean... Was it 2 years ago
He's taken a step back in recent years. He got married. He was making a run at probably gold a couple of years ago. He did really well at a bunch of GPs in a row.
Well, he also led the North America in Planeswalker points for a while.
Yeah, but Planeswalker points aren't really that relevant.
I mean, you have to play in a lot of events.
Yeah, you play a lot of GPs, and you're going to get a lot of Planeswalker points. The thing is, though, that doesn't actually necessarily convert into a lot of pro points, because, if you keep getting, top 16s at GPs, you're only getting, 3 or 4 pro points, whereas top 8s get you a lot more.
Yeah, then we've also got, David Gleicher. He's a frequent Pro Tour competitor. Yep. We've got...
sometimes we have Andrew Beckstrom.
Yeah, Andrew Beckstrom as well. Who's been to the past couple Pro Tours. He's been doing pretty well.
He went 11-4 in Memphis this weekend, and he basically locked up silver.
Oh, wow. All right, so this is now really rough for Kyle, because we see a Rest in Peace come down.
For other regulars in Chicago, a lot of people live in the suburbs and play regularly at Hot Sauce or Pastimes. There's like Joe Bernal or Caleb Durward.
Oh, but Kyle had the engineered explosives in hand. So that's huge. So he put it in play. All right. Wow. Wow.
Yeah. EE on two is really good against miracles.
Yeah. So I think you just leave it, right? You don't crack it yet until.
There's no need. Yeah, until you're going off. Yeah. Or you do it end of turn and then, you know.
Yeah. It's not like Bogner's running like Stifle or something. Right. Yeah. So.
If he draws like Dig, he might want to pop it, but. This is keeping Bogner from being able to put a counterbalance into play.
Yeah, Crimson, I said thank you for it. Thank you very much for the donation. Much appreciated.
Thanks.
That helps out every little bit.
Looking at an Animate Dead in his hand. I think a Cunning Wish, maybe?
Yeah. No, I thought it was a Flusterstorm.
Oh, okay. So he's just waiting for Entomb, basically.
Yeah. That's all he needs.
Yeah.
He's got the mana, and especially now because he can crack explosives in Tomb and
on one turn.
Yeah.
Right. And he has the Cunning Wish for the kill. He also has Duress in his hand now.
Yeah. No, I'm pretty sure there's a Flusterstorm, not a Cunning Wish. But either way, we'll ring up Cunning Wish so people know what we're talking about.
Can I have both? No, maybe not. It's probably just Cunning Wish.
Cunnilingus.
This might be a Brainstorm in response to this Duress, it's looking like. He can set up and treat.
Okay.
Or he can try to hide something. Like, it might be worth it to just entreat and try to kill him.
Does Bogner have the same wedding ring as I do?
Maybe. Are you guys married?
We are married, apparently. No, he doesn't. Okay, it just looked like it. All right. Because I got a black ring, orange middle. Looked like it was black with an orange middle.
It did look like that.
I think his is silver with a gold middle. Oh. But it was just kind of the reflections and stuff. Shut up, Greg.
Looks like Bogner found his second copy of Rest in Peace here.
Did he really?
Yeah.
But that's fine. But, I mean, again, Kyle's got the mana to be able to do everything on his own turn. So that's not going to actually
matter. At the end of Bogner's turn. Flusterstorm on Duress. All
right, fair enough.
So this is three copies of Flusterstorm.
Yeah, it's like I just dominated by team players. Report and bullet normal pro players, everyone. Alright. Talking about pro tour environment.
Flusterstorm, your Flusterstorm? How does that work? Oh, one on each.
Yeah, one on each copy? One. Yeah.
Okay. But why didn't he just pay three mana?
Well, so...
I have no idea what they're doing.
2-3. So Kyle had three copies.
Yes. No. Bogner had three. Kyle had four.
Oh, because of Brainstorm. Yeah.
There's Duress, then Brainstorm, then Flusterstorm, then the second Flusterstorm.
Okay.
So... I don't see the point of the fight over the Duress. It's just going to resolve, right? Maybe not. Yeah, two lands. Then top.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, that Brainstorm kind of hits stuff. So, I agree. Like, I mean, if your opponent Brainstorms, I don't think it's worth fighting over, right?
Typically not. Because presumably they hid their good stuff. And it looks like he did. He hit a Jace.
Let's see.
This Jace is probably Brainstorming. Could also Fate Seal, but he doesn't really know what Kyle's missing necessarily. Ow.
Oh, sorry.
This Jace Brainstorm is looking at, looks like, Rest in Peace. Is that Disenchant? Can't tell if that's Disenchant or not.
In
Bogner is activating Jace's Brainstorm currently. He's thinking about what to put back.
The Disenchant would be huge.
Maybe it's just Entreat the Angels, though.
I think it's just an Entreat, but that would be insane.
Disenchant would be good.
Yeah. Cook, you'll get on the Pro Tour. You seem very up and up on your shit whenever you're talking in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, even Schaefer agrees. Yeah. Schaefer hates everybody.
Yep.
And Conductor, we had Maverick on a little earlier. I think he's still doing pretty well, so we can try to get him for the fourth round.
Pino always does well.
Yeah. What's the win con for the World Gorger deck?
There's a number.
Yeah.
It could be Nephalia Drownyard in play. It could also be Cunning Wish for Stroke of Genius. It could also be Dig Through Time to find Cunning Wish for Stroke of Genius.
Yeah.
Basically, you need something to do with your infinite mana to convert that mana into a game win.
Is he fetching here?
He is fetching in response to the miracle trigger on Entreat the Angels.
Ah.
So this is going to put Guile to the test, because this is presumably going to be a one-turn clock.
Yeah, and he's just got two Animate Deads.
Yeah, so he really just needs Entomb. He might have to blow the Engineered Explosives on two end of turn just in anticipation of having to try to go for the win. Oh, it looks like he's only making two Angels, actually. So it's going to be a two-turn clock, not a...
Yeah, okay.
Not a one-turn. He could have made a one-turn, but he's representing action in his hand.
Because he's got, well, I mean, he's got the other
rest in peace, but that doesn't do anything.
Yeah. And now he's topping.
Okay. Oh, he's Jace Brainstorming, actually.
Oh.
So he finds Red Blast. That could be relevant. He also finds, it looks like, Swords to Plowshares, which definitely is relevant.
Yeah, Swords to Plowshares is actually
Oh, is that Blood
huge.
Moon? That might be Blood Moon.
Was it?
I think it is.
I guess that takes out the Drown win condition.
It takes out... all of Kyle's current lands.
Oh, yeah, that'd be really good. Yeah.
I mean,
Does he probably
plays a Swamp.
I hope.
Maybe?
He better.
He might not.
Booger doesn't have another land, though. Did he already play a land?
He's resolving Brainstorm. Yeah. He has to put two back. I don't think he played a land yet this turn, because he miracled... And then he brainstormed.
Oh, and he fetched. Yeah, okay, so fair enough. Jeskai Way 265, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Let's see. There's some Kappa towns?
This looks like he might be going for Blood Moon. Nope, just passes the turn. So yeah, Kyle, realizing that he has to go for it sooner rather than later, blows the Engineer Explosives on two for Rest in Peace. And looks like he drew Nephalia Drownyard. He might Drownyard himself. Nope, maybe he'll do it end of turn.
So he blew the Rest in Peace.
He did. It's interesting, too, because he wasn't actually being put to the test just yet, and now the Rest in Peace in Bogner's hand is live.
Yeah, this is awkward.
Or maybe, maybe he was floating it with the Jace? Can't tell if it's in his hand anymore, actually. This looks like an activation.
Oh, he was floating it.
This is an activation of Drownyard before Bogner's... Or in response to Brainstorm of Jace.
Wow.
He could top in response.
Oh, yeah, okay, and then draw it?
Yes.
Draw it into his hand? Yeah,
He doesn't need the top anymore. He just needs to get the Rest in Peace.
Yeah.
Also, looks like he has Keranos floating up there.
Yeah, that's what I saw. I saw that, too. Tall Trip, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Let's see.
Now Jace Brainstorm resolves, I think. Yep.
So...
Two Brainstorms and a Forcible.
Did he mill?
Yes, he did.
Okay.
One of the cards was Keranos, another was Top, and another... Okay. Oh yeah, so these are not exiled, is the point of that.
Yeah, okay.
Putting back a Brainstorm and another card here. I think Bogner has it wrapped up now. Kyle just couldn't find Entomb.
Lost Saint, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
That's a Rest in Peace.
Yeah. And Kyle's like, oh, well.
Yep.
And then if he follows up with Blood Moon here.
Yeah. That seems good.
And Bogner swings for...
Yep.
Yeah,
just concede on the spot.
Okay. There was a Cunning Wish, but it doesn't matter.
He's never going to find Entomb.
Yeah. That's all he needed. That's all he needed the entire game was Entomb.
There were a few turns, yeah, where Bogner would have just been dead.
Yeah, I mean, he needed Entomb or Cunning Wish, the whole game.
Cunning Wish for what?
Entomb.
He only plays three in the main?
Yeah, one on the board.
Oh.
I mean, it's still seven copies.
Yeah, but it's just a lot more expensive if you have to Cunning Wish for it.
Wait, aren't he kind... Archie Kind Killer, did you follow Satsu Kawai? Were you are you the killer from back in the day?
The killer?
Yeah.
It's the killer.
Well, we had when Kyle and I were just doing streaming from my couch. we had a killer who was watching, and he was here late all the time. And I'm pretty sure that's
Johnny Turbo.
I know. I think that's killer. Ah, it is killer. there we go. Nice. All right, so we'll bring it back to the booth. We've got a better setup now, killer.
Slightly.
We got a better setup.
It's cold as fuck in this basement.
It is miserable.
That's
in the basement.
It's not better. It's not better.
It's gonna be nice in the summer, though.
It'll be nice and cool.
Yeah, it'll be nice and cool.
No, it'll be just cold because we're gonna be wearing shorts and a t-shirt and flip-flops coming out from the sun. It's gonna be still gonna be 20 degrees in this basement.
It happens. Yeah. All right, do you want... I guess I'll go run up and see if we can get something. Do you want to reset the overlay?
Yeah, I can do that. I think Mark just ate someone. Ugh. Nice. I'm glad you like the decor. I will be resetting the overlay. Whew. Not totally sure we'll be able to get on camera for the last round. It'll probably depend on if people are 3-0 and they can just draw, or if people are paired down, perhaps. See what we can do before the round kicks off, though. Lost Saint asks, how much have you spent on your decks? Oof. That's a tough question. I mean, I think I've spent, it's definitely thousands of dollars, but I also have a collection that's worth thousands of dollars now, so it's hard to really say if it's worth it or not. I would say that for a lot of people, our cards have gone up in value since we've bought them, especially if you're like a Legacy player, and have been for a while, even Modern. But Sir Cucumber asks, how much was a girlfriend? I don't think you can put a price on that. But you also can't really put a price on fun and friends, which is what Magic offers, so there's that. Yeah, Lost Saint, I agree with you. It's a good hobby. I think there are definitely more expensive hobbies out there, and also hobbies where you put a lot of money into it and you don't actually have something you can get money out of it later. You know, like you invest in Magic cards, and if you're smart about your investments and like what you accumulate, you could basically have the game not like necessarily make you money, but you can at least try to just like not lose a lot of money on it. Basically, you can, you know, take what you win from playing, or you know, sell your cards eventually if you're done using them, like for Standard or something. But what can you do? Jeez. Johnny Turbo says hardcore console gamers spend more, I think. I'm not a great expert on that. I don't really play video games myself. Really just Magic, but I presume that if you play a lot of different games, it's a lot of money, and you're not really able to like sell and get out as much value from it. Also, you're buying video games or something, you're not going to be able to like make a profit ever. Whereas, you bought Tarmogoyfs when they were $4 or whatever when they first came out, that's appreciated several 100%, so. RT Killer asks if anyone at the store is playing Oops All Spells. I don't believe we have Oops All Spells. I know we have Bob, who has played Belcher in the past. That's the closest we've come. Apparently, there's a mono blue Belcher deck in Vintage. I didn't know
this. Is there?
Yeah, apparently Randy Bueller made it, and it's awesome. That's what I heard. I don't know what the list looks like, but it sounds fun. Apparently, the only land in the deck is Tolarian Academy.
I like it.
It's pretty sweet.
I like it.
Tolarian Academy is like the coolest land ever.
And you have lots of, you have like tons of, you have all the rocks.
Yeah, it's all of the broken mana.
Yeah, why not?
And stuff to tutor, I suppose.
Fuck it, yeah, let's do it. Let's build it. It won't be expensive.
Apparently Nathan's playing 10 proxy Vintage this weekend, and that's what he's playing.
I try it. It's pretty cool. Why not? And so no matches, no more matches this round.
Okay. Well, the round's almost done.
There were a couple requests from Maverick, so I got Pino. Pino's gonna.
What's his record?
He is X and one.
Okay, so he's 2-1.
Yeah. So sure. he's still got. Yeah, playing
so
for
he's
some money.
Playing for placement.
Yeah, it looks like Zinni is X and L right now.
Ah.
Yeah.
Ooh, if we look at the Vintage Super League, then we can see the Fufuku doesn't want me to give Bueller any credit. He can be a little silly on stream sometimes. I don't know.
I'm okay with Bueller.
I think he's good at talking about Vintage.
Yes.
And maybe Limited. Everything in between, I think a lot of stuff he hasn't been part of the competitive
scene. I mean, I don't know. I don't have.
He's all right.
I don't have qualms with him.
Yeah.
Other people, but again, I don't want to trash talk or whatever.
Apparently, I think it was a modification of something Saito/Sam Black hooked up on the mothership. Not the best list.
All right, fair enough. Oh, here's a list. All right.
Thanks, Jedi.
Thanks,
RT Killer.
What? For fault? We already went over this.
No, he posted the link.
But Jedi Joe just followed.
Look, all right,
so we're thanking Jedi Joe.
Thank you, Jedi Joe.
Thank you, Greg.
Thank you, Jedi Joe. What's going on in this list? A bunch of broken mana.
Black Lotus.
Expedition map. Expedition map to go find.
Four
expedition maps to find your one Tolarian Academy. Don't get it wastelanded.
But you really don't care, right?
Probably not.
Because you're just trying to cast Charbelcher.
Yeah.
Forger Monolith makes sense.
So it's all of the broken mana and four Charbelchers. And all, no Force of Will, right?
No.
Four Pact of Negation. Sorry. Two Force of Will. Two Force of Will.
Oh, okay, sorry. We're looking at the Sorcery column. Yeah, there's no Force of Wills in the Sorcery column.
We don't know if this is the optimized list. Also, four Mishra's Workshop in the sideboard. So this is not the cheapest Vintage deck ever.
No, I'm just resetting this. You can continue.
Oh, you're fine. Four Steel Sabotage on the sideboard. That sounds sweet. I don't think I could ever play Vintage.
No?
Yeah. I don't think it's my style of fun. Maybe if I had all the cards, so I wouldn't feel like card availability was holding me back.
Like an issue? Yeah, sure.
I mean, maybe if it was like a 10 proxy tournament, you could play some sort of like Young Pyromancer deck fairly completely.
I could probably build shops.
If with 10 proxies?
Yeah. Honestly,
you'd probably come close.
Yeah.
They use all of the power, like all of the artifact mana, and then four workshops.
Yeah.
Lotus.
Isn't that 10? Oh,
that's
wait, and 10. Lotus, so that's 11.
Well, five Moxen, four shops, one Lotus. That's 10, but.
I have all the rest of the other cards.
You need all of them. But
yeah.
You might be able to swing it, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know.
At least come close.
Yeah.
Or like variants of shops, because there's a bunch of different ones.
I'm a variant of shops.
Okay.
Do you see my plaid?
You do look like a shops player.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie.
Yeah. As I should.
Yeah.
All right. Good. So looks like are people sitting down?
Seems like.
Oh.
It seems okay.
Oh.
Looks okay.
There we go. All right. We're good.
Get in your chair.
We're good. All right. So you do. I'll do. You do. We'll do. We'll do.
Okay.
Mardu do.
Time. Who is he playing against?
Maybe. I don't know. That's what I was going to go run up and say.
Oh.
So I'll go run up and
see
that.
We'll be able to tell from his forearms.
Maybe. Let's see.
No, maybe not. I don't know who that is.
Let's see. Where did we. Do we mean Strip Mine? Yeah, what the fuck is Wasteland? Strip Mine. That's fair, Greg. Yeah.
What? You can only play one Strip
Mine. Oh, this
mine.
Is the Reanimator guy.
Yes.
Okay.
So he is Joe, I think.
Yeah. All right. So left player's name.
I think it's Joe.
Yeah. Joe A L A N E. Okay. Cool. And he is on Reanimator. Oh, nope. Nope. That's not the right button.
I think this matchup is okay for Maverick.
As long as he doesn't reanimate Elish Norn, like.
Sure. I mean, my point is that Pino has a good amount of ways to interact.
Sure.
Like, he has four Swords to Plowshares. He has Caracas. Dahlia's solid.
We'll give it a second before we start the...
Definitely Elish Norn can be a problem. Also, Grizzlebrand can be a problem.
Yeah.
The thing that I've always seen from Reanimator, at least against Death and Taxes, is that Tidespout Tyrant's really good because it can't get Caracas'd. I don't know if that's necessarily the case, like, what he needs to angle towards against Maverick, though, because Maverick's probably only playing one Caracas, whereas Death and Taxes plays three Caracas.
Mono Blue Charbelcher, top winning deck of Vintage Super League this season. Fair enough. Mono Blue Belcher deck costs $1,000 on MTGO, 16,000 IRL.
Oh.
All right, you know, why not? I'd run four strips, one waste. I'm porn. All right. Fair enough, Killer. Nope. Killer is porn. He's just a very sexy individual.
Yes.
They are just like, they ooze the sex. Mm-hmm. Enos.
Is Pino both. Counting? Pino's counting.
I think so. Every time Pino plays... He orders them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
He does.
Yeah. So.
It's very particular.
Mark, are you allowed to smoke inside all these cardboard boxes? It's not a fire hazard. Unless, like, I'm, like, shoving the coil against it.
You could.
I could, but I'm not going to do that.
It would make it warmer down here.
Yep. just light the whole thing on fire.
Yes.
Kolya Kittim, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Shops does not get enough coverage on Vintage Super League. Yeah, fair. I think it's because people
don't like playing it.
I would like playing it. I see about 20 cards from Vintage Dredge List. Fair enough. You keep an eye on that. I'm going to go through there.
Looks like we're about to be off to the races. I wonder if Pino knows what he's playing against. Looks like a Verdant Catacombs and a Passing of the Turn.
Funky, call it EDH box and then you trade them in a deck. What? Well, since you brought it, you should totally shove the coil against the boxes.
This is now an underground C and a pass. I think Pino has Wasteland in his hand. So he might just want to lead on that.
Ooh.
He also has Green Sun Zenith, so he can waste... Oh, fetching.
Well, he's fetching. Favorite MTG card? Question in chat.
Oh, I actually was thinking about this yesterday. I think it's... My physical, the physical card is the JSS Lord of Atlantis.
All right.
Really cool card.
I actually like, and so we see a daze. All right, so Green Sun Zenith is getting dazed. Pina's got to be a little sad about that. I actually want to say, like, Master Transmuter.
Okay.
I just love just everything that card does.
Sure.
Do
you like the art?
Art's not bad. Art's not bad.
Favorite MTG card.
Blightsteel Colossus, also in general. I love the art on
that's
that.
That's a good favorite.
Yeah, I love the art on that. I love what
the card
does.
It's a cool card.
Yeah, it's good things. It's good things.
That's the thing. Like, favorite card, you gotta like everything about it.
Yeah.
You have to like playing it. You have to like how it looks like aesthetically. The art. The effect of the card.
Killer, we'll talk. We'll talk, Killer.
We'll talk. This looks like a resolving of Careful Study out of Joe.
Yep, into Petal.
Also looks like, the Green Sun Zenith out of Pino was actually dazed.
Yeah, we went over this, Greg.
Sorry, I missed that.
Jeez.
I was looking at chat.
No, that was huge. Yeah.
Was it huge?
I think so.
Why?
Because, I think he was really needing that in order to be able to... Because the rest of his hand doesn't look like it does much.
What was he going
to
get?
He was doing it for one? So I guess maybe it wasn't that big.
Like, he was just going to get, like, Death Rate Shaman?
Probably.
Oh, I guess that is big.
Yeah, that actually... Yeah. All right, so never mind. Yep, all right. I was right.
Yeah.
Damn it, Greg.
Sorry.
Putting these thoughts and figures in my head.
I think Waste going after Underground Sea is not the worst here. Oh, he just has a Death Rate.
All right. Sometimes you got it,
Looks like looking at a force in Joe's hand, perhaps. There's also a Grizzlebrand in his graveyard. And
yeah,
Pino does not currently
scary.
Have a Swords to Plowshares. Here's an Underground Sea.
Fair enough. So, and there is another Petal in Joe's hand.
Okay.
So
he can animate, presumably?
Yeah, and he just drew a land.
Okay.
So he's going to fetch. He's going to get down to 19.
Does he have the reanimation effect, though?
I don't know. That I did not see in his hand. But we'll bring up show and tell. Show and tell. We'll see what he's going to play. Actually, we'll bring up Deathrite Shaman. Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
You know, it's... Damn it, Greg.
Why not?
Yeah, it's good. All right, so... He's got to be going for something, right? Because like, he played the land, fetched, cracked it.
Yes, he exposed it to another wasteland.
Yeah, and...
He must be
and he played the
spell.
Other panel.
Is that so, dig through time?
All right. Sure.
Off of the lotus petals, presumably. So, yeah, so he can leave Grizzlebrand in his graveyard.
So, getting rid of... He has to get rid of six. So, there's an Inkwell and... Inkwell, Grizzlebrand, Daze, and Dig Through Time still in his yard.
Okay.
So, looking at the top seven... I haven't seen Joe. Have you seen him around?
I have not.
All right.
Looks like he found Reanimate.
There's Reanimate.
So this should be a Grizzlebrand.
Animate!
And he's still at a healthy life total, so he's actually be able to activate pretty comfortably. Where are these cards going?
So he's going to go down to...
He's taking Reanimate and Brainstorm, it looks like.
Yeah, and so he'll be he'll be using this card, Reanimate, to bring back, more than likely, Grizzlebrand. Because I don't think he necessarily cares about... I don't think he cares. I don't think he wants to bring back Inkwell, at least at this point in the game.
Okay.
Doesn't necessarily do a lot. And we'll bring up Inkwell Leviathan. Very quick. There we go. So that is going to come into play. Joe's going to get down to 11 here, though. And that'll be thanks.
Yeah, this is a pretty advantage position, I think. Pino not having the force, and it's looking at a hand that just doesn't stand up to Grizzlebrand, really.
No, not really. I mean, he's got some things he can do, right? If he draws a Caracas,
he has Gaddic Teague.
All right, I mean,
so that's
going
to stop any force of wills later. So like,
God, duck. Oh, look at that. Got it.
I mean, this makes it so that if he draws force or if he draws Sword Supply Shares, he can actually nail the Grizzlebrand, presumably.
Sure. Yeah, because it can't be forced.
Right.
And
he has mana to pay for days. And
yeah. It's still. This is still gonna be rough, though.
Fetching here. Might play out the Casali Pride Mage.
Does the Pride Mage actually do anything?
Eh.
I think it's. Isn't it more important to leave a green up for? Just in case that Leviathan,
is there a Leviathan in the graveyard?
Yeah, there's still a Leviathan in the graveyard. So I feel like just leaving the green up is relatively important, right?
Sure.
Our chat is lively. What is happening in chat? I don't even know. Okay, so there, cool. Favorite spot, good. 100 solid more playable. Fraction negotiator. He's fat. No downside for 3-5-5-3. No, there's a downside. Might be a downside. Because they're still talking about what is the favorite cards.
Yeah, negator's a cool favorite card. It was good once upon a time when creatures sucked.
Yes, but you can still get it bolted at that point in time, and then you're like, oh, well, let me just sacrifice three of these permanents.
I mean, if creatures suck, there's less we need for Bolt.
Thoughtseize from Joe. Just going to get down to 9 here.
Yep.
Not if a good I hand take, from Greg.
I mean, it doesn't really even matter what he takes, frankly. He can take Jit. Yeah. Might as well.
Man, remember Crash of the Rhinos? Yeah, maybe.
I don't think there's any way that Pino can race.
I don't think so either.
Without swords.
Yeah. So.
Joe going up to 16.
No. Yeah. No.
Sorry. What was Pino at?
Pino was at 18. He's down to 17.
11, you mean?
Yeah. Same thing.
Yes.
Right. Joe's at 16.
Needs to draw swords to plowshares.
Joe draw the 7 already?
Caracas?
Or no?
I think he drew Caracas.
Did he?
That's what
big.
It looked like.
That's big. But why isn't he just windmill slamming this? No, it can't be. I don't think that was Caracas.
Oh, okay. Attack for
All right.
I feel like it was. No, I guess not.
No, he's hiding it for some reason. If it was,
it really looked like Caracas.
Something tells me, Greg, not Caracas.
Yeah, it wasn't. Yeah, I suppose.
Joe's at 20 life. Oh, 210 life.
Yep.
Eating it. Down to 18.
Mm-hmm. Maybe it was a mother of runes.
Oh.
This might be a concession.
Yeah,
here.
Pino doesn't look super pleased.
Attack for 4, 14. What is this? Mom.
Yeah, it's mom.
Death
mom,
right.
Death right.
Go.
Does he have 2 green mana that he can...
And concede.
Yeah. All right, I gotta put my coat on.
Yeah, you should. It's freaking cold down here.
I've toughed it out. Oh, we never started the time around. Oh.
Probably 35 left.
Oh. No.
40?
I think... No, probably 35.
38?
Right. We'll start at 35. I'll go run up and check. I'll go run up and check. All right. Greg, you get these life totals reset.
All right. You just did it.
Well, I got one of them. I didn't get both of them, Greg.
I'll also change the match record. All right. So that was not the most competitive game. But, I mean, if Pino had drawn a Swords to Plowshares, the Teague was really going to prevent Joe from interacting back. So... I don't think this matchup is terrible for Pino, but I think he's not favored, from what I can tell.
There's such a temperature difference in this basement.
Oh, no kidding.
There's actually 39 minutes left.
Okay.
So we jumped the gun a little bit.
Jumped something.
Oh, I'll jump something, all right. You know it.
I do. Cold as ice.
You're cold as ice. No need to sacrifice our love.
You're in love with the basement?
Yeah. Love this basement.
I'm in love with the basement.
Freddy's Nightmare. Was that before or after you got fingered? Oh, God. Got the joke.
Yep.
Got the jokes.
You got it.
But thank you for following.
It's important to make yourself laugh.
Oh, man. All right, let's see. Did we miss anything good in chat? Five lands. Elf, Beckstrom, Pepper's Farm members. That's Sir Cucumber. Gosh, probably. Huh?
Beckstrom?
I don't know. Maybe.
Okay.
Crimson really wants Tarmogoyf.
Oh, they're really expensive.
Trading 4 Snapcasters for Tarmogoyf. I'll do it.
I'd probably just keep playing the Snapcasters. I think they're almost better.
Possibly, right?
I mean,
like, situationally?
So, Goyf is better in Legacy, Snapcaster's better in I guess it depends on what you want to play.
Yeah.
But, like, think about how much cheaper Splinter Twin is to build than Abzan. In Modern.
Sure.
It's like drastically cheaper.
What is Rhino sitting at now?
Rhino? Like $5?
Really?
Yeah.
Just because it's a rare?
It's a rare and it's opened a crap ton.
Alright. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Gibson finally mentioned the waffle. What are you guys playing? They're playing Legacy on the camera. We're just watching them, commentating on them.
Yes.
Picking apart every move that they make so they feel self-conscious later.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And, I mean, Greg and I are also playing footsie, currently.
Yeah.
And a little bit of Doctor, probably later. And then then we're going to, my favorite game, Don't Tell Mommy.
Okay.
Yeah. I like that you just said okay with a straight face to that. Just like, okay.
Okay.
but like, sir, like I just said something like intelligent, okay, that you were just like something deep and intelligent.
This is how I talk to you, Mark. Peb doesn't like Twin. He's hating on Twin.
Yeah, look to see Twin banned next. Maybe.
Twin's not going to get banned. It's not really that, like, if you want to beat Twin, you can, I think. Like,
yeah.
Abzan is so good against it.
Yeah. Like, Abzan's good against everything, though.
Twin's not, like, powerful because of the combo. It's powerful because they can win without the combo. If like,
sure, yeah.
But that's largely contingent on how familiar the pilot is with, like, how to play the deck and how to sideboard with it. Like, I don't see why that's, like, bad to have in the format.
Yeah. I don't know. I'd, like... They could make Modern fun. Unban everything, print Force of Will, and Daze.
I don't think it's that bad now. I don't know.
There's a lot of Abzan, and it's hard to really do anything about it.
Eh, I think people just don't play the format enough.
Yeah.
I know I don't.
I think that Mono Blue Mud deck that I came up with for Modern...
Okay.
...probably has a decent matchup against Abzan. Like, sure. When I was looking at it.
I mean, I think and a lot of things have a pretty decent matchup against Abzan. Like, they're a 50-50 deck.
Where's that draft coming from? That was freezing. Did you just feel that?
Yeah.
It was like, I'm a cold air. This happens.
There's not a lot of heat in this store.
Yeah, no. And it looks like Joe is resolving a mulligan here.
Sure.
So, Greg looking happy on his hand, at least.
Yep.
So, you know what? At least somebody's happy tonight.
I'm doing all right.
Greg Pino's so happy that he's scratching his arms.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a happy thing. It's a happy thing. Prevalence of the deck is why Pod got banned. But I also do agree that Modern, nobody plays Modern enough. Like, because there's so much shit you can do in that format. Because it is a huge card pool.
It is.
And a lot of, like, stupidly powerful things are banned.
Yeah.
So, like, you should be able to find things that, like...
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't even seem like the best lists of, like, Affinity have been settled on. You know, like, there's such diversity in, like, how people are building. Yeah. And if there were more big tournaments all the time, you would see more, like, evolution within the card pool in the same way things get cycled through in Legacy.
Yeah.
Like, there's a lot of metagaming you have to do, and you can become a master of your archetype, but then also know how to... mold your deck like week to week or tournament to tournament to try to, like, there's enough cards available that you can make those adaptations every week.
Yeah, and I think Abzan, you just have to go bigger then, right? Killer Clown, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Much. Greg just is having a chuckle to himself.
Ho-ho. Oh, about Mother of Runes?
I don't know.
I'm a big fan of Mother Runes.
I know you
should
love
pull her
some
up
Mother
on
runes.
The.
You want some Mother Rune action?
I do.
Oh, I'll give you some Mother Rune.
You know, there's alternate art. There's a printing coming out soon. I forget which thing it's in. Here. Like which product? It might be like a dual deck or something. But there's Therese Nielsen art for Mother Runes.
I'm looking forward to
it. I'm probably not gonna switch.
No.
Yeah.
And there's a careful study from Joe. We'll bring that up as well.
Okay.
So he's probably going to put something that he wants to actually... Oh, and there's an Elish Norn in the yard. That's rough. Yeah. Freeman, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
Wow, Sir Cucumber thinks the new Mother of Runes art is terrible.
Have you seen it? Have you actually seen it?
I have, yeah. It's Therese Nielsen art, so I like it. I mean, I get why it's kind of silly to have it as the Mother of Runes art, because she looks really young. She doesn't really look like a mother, but...
Oh, Greg's favorite card, Massacre.
Oh, God.
Oh, that was...
That's horrifying.
That was pretty rough.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Is he stuck on one land, though?
Yeah, and...
Or no land?
Yeah, so Joe Bajuka-bogged away a lot of the scary things that Joe had. Yeah. And then
that's
Wasteland.
That's the new art in there.
All right.
You tell me if you like it.
Yeah,
it's not bad art.
I don't mind that. Like, I wish it was in foil, because I bet you that foil would be pretty as hell.
Yeah. If there was a foil version, I'd probably actually switch. Because that is one of the things that I'm not going to pay out for, is the foil Urza's Legacy Mother of Runes or whatever.
Yeah. And Pebblicle TV, you're welcome. And you're going to make us cry a little bit. Did you read their comment?
Which
it's very nice. We're very happy that we're streaming.
Oh, good.
It's good. I know. I like it.
Yeah.
So, Greg, Deathrite Shaman, eating the land, gonna play a Sylvan Library, so we'll bring that up, and then another Deathrite Shaman. This is not looking great for Joe.
No lands.
Yeah.
This is how I like to see Legacy games decided. One person with no permanence.
The other person with permanents that only hate.
Yes.
On the particular deck that the person's playing.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't play it, but I am a fan of Rug Delver. I like when both players have no permanents on turn four. I really do like that. So yeah, this is a Bajuka Bog. That's crazy.
Yeah, alright.
Do we miss Bajuka Bog eating a creature in the graveyard as well?
I don't believe so.
Okay.
Oh, no, Bajuka Bog did eat a creature, yeah. But
off of Careful Study?
Yeah, that's right. Disgusting. Death Ray Shaman did. It was a Nullish Norn that was in the yard, too.
Ah, lovely.
Alright, so there's a Scribranger.
A Greg Pino special.
Yep, he loves...
He loves some Ranger.
Scrib?
R. Y.
Why? There we go.
Come on, Mark.
Have we missed some...
Damage, probably.
I don't think so, actually. Not yet.
Maybe not. Maybe now.
No, maybe actually I think
maybe
we missed
the
a point.
Death Rite attacked, yeah.
Yeah. And Malphius, I'm paying attention.
That wasn't Hornet Queen, right? I'm making that up. That just looked like Hornet Queen.
Oh my god, I hope it was Hornet Queen.
It can't be.
Where?
On top of his library. It's not a Hornet Queen.
It's gotta be a Hornet Queen. No, he's shuffling. Let's see.
We're never gonna know.
No, we're never gonna know.
Maybe it was like a Rhino or something.
He does play Rhino. He is playing Rhino.
Yeah,
deck,
he plays
so.
Two Rhinos like a psychopath.
Yeah. Yeah, Greg is just now at 19. I mean, nothing's happened to him. So.
Yeah, he's just fetched once.
And so, that's a...
Oh.
Did he fetch twice?
No,
maybe?
They're saying that he kept three cards with Sylvan Library last turn.
Oh, okay.
That makes sense why there's so many cards in his hand. But that's a concession from Joe.
Yay! Solved us in our not good life trackingness.
Sorry, people in chat.
Yay. Oh, wait, and that's just... Oh, no, because Reanimator took game one.
Yeah, going to game three.
I was like, and that's... Nope, no, it's not
and
game.
That's the match. You want to pull up Containment Priest?
I'll pull up Containment Priest.
Cool.
You like some Containment Priest?
Either that or Tidespout Tyrant.
We'll do a little bit of both. You know what? I'll treat you, Greg. All right? You've been good to me.
Okay.
You've been good.
I hope this doesn't get massacred. That would be gross. You can pull up Massacre next if you'd prefer.
I already pull up Massacre. It's already up, Greg.
Okay.
But we'll pull up Tide Pouts. Tide
Pout.
Tide Pout.
Tide Pout.
When do you need a little pout and you got a little Tide?
Yep.
Maybe you're not washing your clothes and you spilled Tide on your clothes and you didn't realize it and now it's stained.
And now you're
so
sad.
Now you're pouting.
Yeah, you're sad. You're sad.
I like it. Because you stained your clothes using
Tide.
I like it. I like it. All right, Burning Art, thank you for pointing that out. All's well, thank you for following. Much appreciated. You did, he cracked to fetch. Yeah, that would be... I agree. There's no way, like... Nick Fit could play Hornet Queen, right?
Maybe one.
That's what we should get Gleichnir to pod into from Grave Titan.
That's a good point. Yeah, you gotta go further up the curve.
Yeah. You just go.
Keep going.
Because it's 7, right? Or is it 8?
It's 7.
That's what I thought it was 7.
4, right. green.
That's good. That's what you gotta do.
3 pips.
Zillatrix, thank you for following.
Thank you.
See, we're doing good tonight.
Yeah, killing it.
We stream, look.
Boom,
how
A-team.
Many we've gotten all, I know. Lead team. Best.
Yeah.
Best commentator combo.
A-team.
If Spikemo's still here, they might argue that Tyler has to, like, maybe sandwich. Maybe Tyler's sandwich between us.
Maybe.
But Tyler's abandoned us.
I think we could take Cedric plus kind Patrick of. Sullivan. I think we could do it.
Oh, we could do it.
You sit what on if, Cedric's head. I'll try to not die to Patrick until you've beaten Cedric.
Pegasus Bishop, thank you for following as well. Yeah, no, I don't know. I'd actually, like, let's, we'll just do a combo stream.
With who?
Patrick Sullivan and, Cedric Phillips.
If they want to have us, I'd
I'd do that in a heartbeat. Yeah.
I would do a basketball one if they like that. They're both into basketball. Or a wrestling one. I know Cedric's into wrestling. You and Cedric could just wrestle, and me and Patrick can talk about it. That would be great.
Just have a car. Just have a cartwheel contest.
Yeah.
Cedric did a cartwheel. I can still do cartwheels.
He kind of did a cartwheel.
I think I can do them. I think I can still do them pretty well.
I've never.
You've never done a cartwheel?
No.
Oh, you're missing out.
Maybe.
Yeah. I don't know. Did the capoeira for a while.
Yeah.
But now I've gotten fat.
Yeah.
Need to lose weight again.
Do more capoeira.
Yep. I would love to actually, but it's hard. It's like it's also pretty expensive.
Yeah, I would say
in the city at least it's really expensive. It's cold as fuck.
I know, I'm horribly out of shape because I haven't been riding my bike everywhere.
Oh, man.
If anyone's not aware, Chicago is a very bike-friendly city because it's so damn flat.
Nick Fit can play everything. Argarth! 12, thank you for following.
Thank you.
Yeah, much appreciated.
Also, Pegasus Bishop.
Yeah, you just don't listen. I'm
90% don't listen to you.
looks like both players looking at their seven.
That looks like debating. Two knights, a mom. Looks like a very fair hand from what I could see. Maybe that's a containment priest.
Crimson, I'll let them know. I'll let them know that he put some deck boxes on their site.
I think Pino's hoping that Joe doesn't have a really busted hand. Because I don't think he has a swords to plowshares. Joe fetching end of turn. This might be a very quick combo.
Yeah. All right. So let's see. Joe's going down to 19.
Yep.
Baby Blue, thank you for following. Much appreciated. And guys, just so everybody knows, on Wednesdays we stream Modern, 7:30 Central Time.
From MTG Card Market.
Yep. And Thursdays we stream Legacy again, from MTG Card Market as well. That's Legacy as well, 7:30 again, Central Time. Drummer Boy, thank you for following. Much appreciated.
Mondays, Wednesdays, Thursdays.
Yeah, Mondays, Wednesdays, Thursdays.
Yeah.
Yep. Possibly, now that I have Fridays off.
Yeah.
Or that Fridays, like, Rachel works and everything.
Right.
I'm considering doing Standard. I don't know.
From here or from Card Market?
From here. Okay. Unfortunately, Card Market apparently doesn't have anything that fires reliably enough other than draft, and there's no way in hell I'm commentating on draft.
Right.
So,
whereas Standard here will always get like 20 people plus.
Yeah. So, Chad, how do you feel? Would you guys want to see some Standard from us on Fridays?
That could be fun.
Yeah.
It might be a little bit tougher consistently getting commentators.
I mean, it basically always had me, and I would just drink.
Yeah.
So, early November, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Scripts were disabled, and I couldn't see that they had it. Oh, okay.
This is a quick exhume on Tidespout Tyrant.
Oh, look at how topical.
Yep.
Yeah, we weren't paying attention at all. But basically, he cracked pedal to... he entombed at the end of Greg Pino's turn, cracked a pedal, or played the pedal, cracked the pedal, and played an exhume. We'll bring up exhume.
This is basically the best reanimation target against a lot of the fair decks. Just because once it's in play, you can just start casting cantrips. You know, like if you get to untap with it, your fail rate is pretty minuscule, I think.
Oh, I'd agree. Does Greg have a swords?
I don't see one. I also don't see a wasteland.
What's that black? It's got to be a planeswalker. It's got to be one of the black planeswalkers.
Is it?
It's a completely blacked out car. What the hell else is it?
Where would he have gotten one of those?
I don't know. Anywhere?
I suppose. They're really expensive.
Are they?
Yeah. What planeswalker can Maverick play anyway?
Garrick?
Garrick Relentless?
No, the... No,
the five mana Garrick?
I thought it was Wild. I thought Wildspeaker got a black print.
I don't think so. I don't know why he'd play Wildspeaker either, though.
Liliana, perhaps?
Maybe.
So Thoughtseize. Okay.
Liliana.
Oh, so this actually could be interesting here, though. Because Thoughtseize and Joe doesn't have another.
Gives him a way to.
There we go.
Yeah, it gives him a way to use his Force of Will. So he's bouncing Pino's land.
He's gonna tap to make some mana?
Yep.
I'm guessing in response.
Probably. Thoughtseize is countered. Not losing life there.
Nope. Did I make him lose life?
You think you might have.
Yes,
he's attacking for 5 now, so I think Pino should be at 14.
Okay. There we go.
Is it Elspeth Nightiron? I don't think it is. I don't think there was a black border printing or a blacked out.
I don't think there was. Not for Nightiron.
Whatever
Aaron,
it was called. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. This is a fun little game. Brainstorm being played by Joe.
This is just like an altered version of something, or I don't know. I don't even know. I don't know what it could be.
And no Dredge around tonight, Drummer Boy. Unfortunately, Kevin was not here. Kevin's been coming.
I think it was just a Pajukabog.
Oh, that was just very black.
Very
okay.
Dark.
So there's Pajukabog, sure. But Kevin Kingsley is our resident Dredge player.
Yes.
And he was not here tonight. He has been coming pretty regularly on. What are we looking at?
Joe dropping to 17, cracking a fetch.
So I expect some dredge on Thursday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kevin is a very adept dredge pilot. Dredge really has not been getting a lot of love in Legacy the past few years relative to prior years. Probably largely in part to Deathrite Shaman and just increased player like familiarity with the deck, because there are a lot of ways, like cute, weird ways to interact with dredge and get little edges that players a few years ago, when the people were newer to Legacy, might not have been aware of. So it's one of those learning curve decks, sort of like playing against like Living End kind of in Modern. Like, you learn how to play against the deck and like what angles to shoot. I think that Pinot is at 9. Actually.
Okay, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, bouncing by you here.
After with another Entomb,
yeah,
for Elishnorn, and that's probably going to be game.
Yeah, if he has reanimate for Elishnorn here, could be pretty gross. Untapping here.
Yeah, and so
Pino has to discard it end step.
Yeah, this is pretty brutal.
Indeed, this looks like a reanimate. Gonna bounce the Pajukabog probably.
I think you target the mom. I guess it doesn't matter because it's going to be in play. Yeah, so never mind. So there's nothing really in the yard that you're even worried about. But he did drop to 10.
Yes. Yes.
Greg goes Lava Axe.
That's the game.
All right. So do we want to see if we can find another match?
Sure. I'll go.
You'll go up there?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll bring it back to the booth, guys. Yeah, all right. So it doesn't sound like there's a ton of support for standard. M. Grishin, I'll ask Jason to post his five color doomsday list on the Facebook page. Mustang Baby, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Sorry you missed that. Let's see. What's a bummer? Dredge is really underrated. Yeah, I think it's probably underrated. Yeah, by the way, when are you doing a couch stream again? I want to see the I don't know. I'll have to do that at some point. I just got a brand new apartment, and it's going to be much more conducive. It's got a lot more room, so we never know. Maybe I'll do one as like a moving-in party for me. Who knows? Who knows? It'll be good. Does a rich guy have the Phyrexian Elishnorn? No. No, those are I think, two. Kyle's got a limit as far as like what he will get. So he hasn't gotten the foil forces or anything yet. And though that Phyrexian Elishnorn is very pretty, that's a awesome card. I just found out, yeah, but I don't even know. I'm just talking. I just found out there's going to be a Tempest Remastered set on MTGO. I don't know. I'd be okay. Just for scroll and waste. Was LED in Tempest? I don't know. See? So there might be some other stuff. Stop paying attention when I saw it was just MTGO. Yeah, that's fine. What is behind you? I believe those are all card boxes that are back there. So just card deck things. Kron TV, thank you for following. So like 100 card count boxes, 400 card count boxes, 800 card, 2000 card, etc., etc. Is the guy who was playing Fauna Charmin and Blue Stuff still in the same deck at Modern and did well? I'm not quite sure, in all honesty. I did see the guy playing that deck. I think that was Pino, right? I think Pino was playing it. Yeah. Yes, so yes, that would be the guy. Yep. Pino always plays some sort of fair deck. And he pretty much always does well. Unfortunately, tonight, Reanimator kind of took it from him, but that was it. And I'll get the, let me actually write all these down that we want. I'll get the Maverick deck list. I'll try to get him to post that too. All right, so let's see. Maverick.
Everything's wrapping up.
Doomsday. And then, what was the, Enchantress. So I'll get all these guys to try to post their list to the Facebook page for us, guys. They don't even finish that sandwich, but he had his deck list anywhere. Yeah. Okay, and then Fauna for Modern.
Yep.
From Pino.
It looks like people like their decks. It looks like the finals was a split between Tony and Nick. So Miracles and Esper Stoneblade was the final split.
Oh, all right, fair enough. Zillatrix, we don't sell cards. Both of our partners, MGG Card Market, and then also Chicagoland Games Dice Dojo,
yep,
they both sell cards. You can find them through their respective websites, which is in their information below the stream, or on TCG Player.
Yeah, they're both on TCG.
Yep. So you guys can definitely find either one of them.
And if you buy through them, feel free to put in the comments that you were directed to them from our stream, because that would be great.
And as far as an Ad Nauseam deck, we could I'll ask Phil. I'll ask Phil to post his.
I mean, Phil plays like a pretty stock Ant deck, from what I remember. Yeah.
We'll put it on there.
Yeah.
I mean, he does pretty well.
Yeah.
I'd consider him
he's
a voice
rated
of authority on Storm in general.
He's done very well at a lot of SCGs.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I mean, he's definitely cashed GPs, but I don't know if he has a top 8 yet.
Yeah.
But he's one of the best players in the store, I'd say.
Yeah. So, and guys, with that, so that is going to be the end of the stream tonight. That was all four of our rounds, so we definitely do appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody tuning in, thank you everybody who followed. We got a lot of follows tonight. We really appreciate that, especially since we didn't have a giveaway, which is awesome.
Wednesday, Thursday, though, I think we
should. Wednesday, Thursday, we're giving away
Thursday?
Time Spiral, right? Is it foil?
Yeah, it's a Japanese Time Spiral.
Oh, Japanese Time Spiral.
Yeah.
All right, so Thursday we're giving away Japanese Time Spiral. Wednesday, I have no idea what we're giving away.
Probably something.
Yeah, probably. I mean, definitely something. Jameson over at MTG Card Market definitely hooks us up with the giveaways on Monday, on Wednesdays and Thursdays. So, guys, make sure you tune in. We'll do that. On Mondays, I have T-shirts again that I want to give away. I'll start doing that when I'm a little less behind and stuff. So, hopefully, that'll be not this week. After this week, I'll have everything shipped out. So, it'll be good. Past that, I'm trying to think what else. Yeah, so again, Wednesdays, 7:30 Central Time, we'll have Modern.
Yep.
Thursday, 7:30 Central Time, we'll have Legacy. And then Monday, 7 o'clock Central Time.
Yep.
Legacy. So it's good. So that's where it's sitting right now. Guys, let us know on Facebook or send me messages on here if you guys do want to see some Standard on Fridays.
That's probably the next thing we would be looking into adding, maybe.
Yeah. I think that's really the only other thing. Because, I would do Modern on Fridays, but it doesn't apparently reliably fire.
Right.
And I wish Legacy on Fridays had kind of taken off.
Yeah, and, it could be cool to stream on Sunday afternoon, but then you have the competition with...
Yeah, I'm not... Saturday and Sunday
is not... worth
it. I'm not gonna even try to
try
compete
get into
that
dogfight.
Yep. No, not at all. If anything, I'll start... if I get bored,
uh-huh,
I would just... host the
with
GP
different commentary
stream, and then just actually we should do that next GP
that
they're doing. We'll just do it and we'll just commentate over everything they're saying and it'll be great.
That sounds like it could go well.
Oh, I think so. A couple beers, that'd be great.
Yeah,
Quaskle Loss, thank you for following, much appreciated.
Thank you.
The killer can see the couch, it'll be good. Or
yeah,
the coach, one of the two.
Braz asking why it's only four rounds. Well,
yep,
you know, it's almost 10:30.
Yeah, so yeah, we cap it. We start it we cap it at four rounds,
yeah,
just because
it's a weeknight.
It's a weeknight, everybody
we all
works.
Have to work in the morning.
Yeah. So
how many people are on our team?
On the Wooburg team?
I mean, if you're counting everyone who is casted, it's a lot.
It's a chunk. If you're counting by people that are actually sponsored, then it's
you.
Anybody that will take an extra... Well, you wore the t-shirts. You and Kyle have worn the t-shirts.
We've only been to one big event so far. People
We've had t-shirts.
That's true.
GP New Jersey.
We did not.
No.
At SCG Indy, we were all wearing the Bluebird shirts.
Sydney and
did they have them in Vancouver?
Oh, they never got their fucking shirts.
Yeah,
actually.
They didn't wear them.
Oh, they should have worn them.
Those clowns.
I know. Very upset.
The modern guys gotta pick up their shit.
Yeah. Crimson, good night, man. Malthus, good night. You have a good one.
All right.
That's about it. Yeah, so we'll wrap it up. Thank you again, everybody, for tuning in. Check out our YouTube page. Most of the streams have been posted there. I got to get back to the recent ones and post the actual match listings and stuff. But that should be done this week as well. So thank you again. Brahmand TV, thank you for following. Appreciate it, everybody. And we'll see you guys on Wednesday or Thursday. We're good. All right. See you guys. Boop, 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 boop.